And a very pleasant good evening, everybody, and welcome to WRMG TV 12 and also Television 97's coverage of Red Bay Tiger football tonight. The Red Bay Tigers are taking on the Sheffield Bulldogs. We got, of course, Miss Katrine Moore is going to be joining us on the pregame with some pregame announcements here in just a minute. But we got Keith Kennedy down on the sideline. Keith, until Miss Katrine gets ready to roll, you missed the game last week, a tough loss for the Red Bay Tigers on the road. We'll turn it over to Miss Katrine. I'll be back with Keith. All right, here we go.
And what a beautiful evening it is. We are just minutes away from an exciting football game between the Red Bay Tigers and the Sheffield Bulldogs. Prior to the kickoff, we respectfully request that you stand. Gath Weatherford, a student at Red Bay High School, will lead in prayer.
Lord, thank you for this day. We thank you for the men and women who have fought and gave their lives to give us our freedoms and this freedom to play football. Lord, we pray that we will show sportsmanship, and in all we do, let it honor you. I pray safety over the players tonight, and Lord, keep us safe as we travel back home. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen.
Thank you for continuing to show respect as members of the American Legion, Marion Post 120, raise the flag. The Red Bay Marching Band will play our national anthem as the symbol of our nation moves skyward. Give your undivided attention to the stars and stripes. There should be no moving about in any area of the stadium at this time.
The Red Bay Tiger Marching Band performing before the game here tonight. I'm Jack Ivey. We got, of course, the world-famous Keith Kennedy down on the sideline. Byron Hellams here with us tonight as well. Denise back at Control Center. I want to tell you how much we appreciate you for joining us on our broadcast here tonight. We're not only got the game on radio, but, Keith, we're streaming this game live on our Facebook account tonight. So we only invite you folks to share this link so everybody that's all across the country that couldn't make it to the game tonight, they can watch it video tonight. We weren't able to do that down at Lamar County, just didn't have the right cell signal and everything down there, but we got it here tonight, and hopefully everybody's going to enjoy the broadcast. Keith Kennedy, you missed last week, but the Tigers came up a little short, and so we just couldn't punch it in at the right time, and we let them score a touchdown when we was trying to get back in it, but just wasn't meant to be down at Lamar County.
Yeah, I understand. We were in the game and just couldn't make it happen there, like you said, when we needed to. But the effort was good, I think. And so, you know, maybe tonight we can come out here and get a good effort and maybe get ahead tonight. You know, it seems like most of the season we've been playing from behind and we've never been ahead. And it makes it a little more – puts a little more pressure on you and sometimes you don't perform just as well when you got a little more pressure on you. But hopefully tonight we can get out here and get a good start and have a good game.
No doubt about it. Want a sandwich. We appreciate Max Howell for joining us down there the other night. The only thing that Max didn't quite eat as much as you do on a road trip, but so we'll have to give him credit for that.
All right.
Max said he might be joining us online tonight. Once again, okay. We're live. We got crews tonight, not only here, and we got a crew, of course, over at Alcorn Central with Belmont playing tonight. We also got a crew over at Tishomingo County High School, the Tish County Braves, taking on New Albany. So three big games as far as our broadcast coverage here tonight. I invite you to call a friend, let me know, and let me know if you're enjoying the game out there. But let me know also how it looks on your cell phone or your computer, iPad. We're going to be, of course, broadcasting the live on Facebook Live tonight. Today's game brought to you by Mike Engel at Engel Farms, along with Keith Kennedy and Alton Barksdale and all the folks at Stadium Pros, by the Medical Clinic of Red Bay. Located, of course, at 209 Hospital Road, Family Medicine, Sports Medicine, and Geriatrics. We're talking about the Medical Clinic of Red Bay, Dr. Fabianchi. Also on the broadcast today is Alpha Insurance. Your agent there, of course, is Mr. John Cook. The Cardinal Drive-In also on our broadcast here tonight. Community Spirit Bank, your hometown bank with hometown solutions since 1908. Also on our broadcast tonight is Bay Tree Gift Company, your complete gift headquarters, located right next to WRMG. And also located next to 4th Street Grill and Steakhouse. Well, now the captains making their way down a little bit. We're still a little bit away from the kickoff game tonight, about 10 minutes or so. We've already had our prayer before the game tonight, and also we've had our national anthem. So we're about ready to get the coin toss here in a little bit, and we'll get this game underway. Our great sponsors include Albin Mason Construction Company, Mr. Albin Mason, Dr. Ralph Nix Family Dentistry, by Tiffin Motorhomes, by Fastwick Car Wash. Also, that's Miss Ann Vinson by the Deaton Funeral Home of Red Bay and Belmont. Also, Dickie Sparks at Sparks CPA Firm on our broadcast here tonight. Ronald Thorne, your State Farm agent. There's when things go wrong, they'll help you in life go right. Call them at 256-356-4459. Mississippians as well as Alabamians. Now, we are here for you. Ronald Thorne, of course, now can write insurance in Alabama and Mississippi. Also, a big shout-out tonight to Wicked Marinero, serving great pizza from our family of yours, made from scratch pizza. Also, the cheese sticks, the five cheese ravioli, shrimp alfredo, much, much more. And they'll have online ordering real soon. Right now, they've been covered up, but they really, really, really do appreciate your business. Once again, at Wicked Marinero. Also, Predator Pest Control on a broadcast here today. Your insect predator. Don't forget, for all your pest control needs, we take care of all your termite problems. So, it's 20 years' experience. Clay and Ted Weatherford, of course, and Mr. Eddie Deaton. I'm going to give you Eddie's local number down in Red Bay, 662-315-2841. Also, want to say hello to Bill Donna Weatherford and Pam Moore and, of course, Kathy Kellum and all the folks at Belmont Pharmacy. They got a brand-new pharmacy that's now open in Red Bay. It's called Red Bay Pharmacy. It's out on the Golden Road. You'll want to check that out for him. Also, want to thank your Edward Jones agent, Mike Jones, on our broadcast here tonight. Find out how he can get you all fixed up with investments. And, of course, Mike Jones is a man to see at 128 North Jackson Avenue, 256-332-7924. You folks that I'm seeing online tonight, Mr. John Tariski, Randy Holland, Coach Mayfield, all you folks, Bill Cox, Angie Stevens, Janice Collum, Miss Ham there. And also I see we got Mr. Mike Scotto on there with us tonight. Also Holly Louie, David Brown is joining us as well. Do me a favor. Some of them may have already rolled off and I couldn't see them, but do me a favor, share this link so the other folks will know exactly how they can enjoy Red Bay Tiger football since they can't be here tonight. So once again, leave us some notes on there. Let us know how the game looks and how it sounds. And the main thing is we want you to enjoy this football game live since you can't be here in person in Red Bay tonight. Today's game brought to you by Swan Chums Restaurant and Catering. Of course, they have got some brand new hours. You know, they were just open 5 to 1. Now, they're open Monday through Wednesday 5 to 1. They're open on Thursday 5 to 7, Friday 5 to 8, and Saturday 5 to 8. So brand new hours from Swamp John's, located at the intersection of 24247. You can dine in or carry out. One thing I wanted to tell you about, you know, there's the Freedom Hills Disc Golf Tournament is holding a fundraising tournament for Generations Nursing Home this Saturday, October the 15th. That's going to be at the Freedom Hills Disc Golf Course, located at the Dixie Youth Baseball Fields in Red Bay. Registration 11:30 to 12:30. The players meet at 12:45. They're going to tee it off at 1 o'clock. The entry fee is $10. That's the Freedom Hills Disc Golf is holding a fundraising tournament for Generations Nursing Home facility in Red Bay. That's coming up this Saturday. We're live tonight on WRMG TV 12 and also Television 97. I'm Jack Ivey. We got the world famous Glenn Graham out there checking in with us tonight. And Glenn, hopefully it looks good at your wherever you're watching tonight. Like I say, we're streaming this online, and of course, as we go on, more and more people will get online with us. Keith, I know you've got to make your way out. We got the captains coming at you right there, but I want to say how much we appreciate Franklin County Probate Judge Barry Moore, Allen and Ash Harden at Harden Heating and Cooling, your York dealer, by Tiffin Supply, Tiffin Appliance Company, by Dr. Rick Wooten at Wooten Chiropractic, by Bay Diesel, Chris and Valerie Marr, and also Redmont Heating and Cooling with Patrick Brooks. Keith, our captains, as you can see, that's all of the seniors, but only part of them will go out. The senior captains, who are they?
Mr. Hunter Towler, Mr. Mr. Rooker, and Mr. Max Bullen, and Mr. Louie.
And they'll be heading across the way. We're still waiting on the captains from Sheffield across the way. I hadn't even noticed that they're not over. I see them making their way. Tiger's going to be their blue helmets and blue pants and blue shirts tonight as well. So got a little trim of that orange in there as well. So we're excited about getting this game underway here tonight. So do me a favor. Good to see Mr. David Connolly out there. Mr. David, we appreciate you checking us out tonight. And Miss Janice said she shared it, said it looking and sounding good. Remember, if you've got a tablet, like an iPad or Android tablet or whatever, you can watch this on Facebook there. You can watch it on your computer, watch it on your cell phone. Probably you get a little bit bigger device, and if you've got some of the Roku boxes or smart TVs that's got the Facebook app on it, you can actually watch this on your TV. Appreciate Tristed Insurance, Kim and Caleb Wells, Mike Moore, Brenda Persia, locations in Belmont and Red Bay. I'll give you Brenda's number down in Red Bay, 256-356-4804. You know, when you become a customer of ours, you become family. We'll take the uncertainty out of insurance and make sure you have the protection you need. That's Tri-State Insurance. Also, MedExpress of Red Bay, formerly known as Keller Practice. That's not Kayla Humphreys, your nurse practitioner. They're open Monday through Thursday about 8 to 5. They accept all major insurances. You can call them at 256-356-8907. Also, Kim Lindsay does all your monogramming and screen printing, 256-668-0142. You can contact her on Facebook, or you can give her a call, 256-668-0142. Well, they're heading out to center field right now. Keith Kennedy is going to be right in the middle of them with a microphone, and you'll hear the coin toss live right here on WRMG. I want to say hello to everybody over at the Tiger Den tonight. Y'all make some noise over there and get ready to support the Tigers. Tiger Den, great food over there tonight. We appreciate it. We'll take you now to midfield. Listen in.
This is Mr. Burbank. He'll be your umpire.
Good luck to you.
Let's see who we got here. Mr. Cheatham, yes, Gary Evans. How you doing?
Good. How about you?
All right. 27, Mr. Hampton.
How you doing?
Gary Evans. How are you, young man?
All right.
Mr. Winston.
Thank you.
Gary Evans. You got to be Mr. Latrade. Did I say that right? Okay. All right, here's what I expect tonight out of you guys, is to be leaders in this football game, okay? Y'all are chosen for this position for a reason, okay? We're here to play football, which is blocking and tackling, okay? Nothing else. Y'all take charge of your team. Y'all take charge of your team, okay? Is that fair enough?
Yes, sir.
Keep us out of it, all right? We want to watch y'all perform. That's what we want to see, okay?
Yes, sir.
All right. Sheffield, you're the visiting team. I got a coin here. That side is, can you see that, heads?
Yes, sir.
That side's tails. Can you see that? Tails and heads, okay? All right, you're going to call it. What's your call?
Heads.
Heads is your call. If I drop it, I'm going to flip it again. His call is heads, okay? What do you see there?
Heads.
See that? Okay.
You want to defer?
You want to defer?
Yes, sir.
All right.
Sheffield won the toss, and they deferred to the second half.
So Keith Kennedy right there in the middle with the officials there, and Sheffield has won the toss. They've deferred, so the Tigers are going to get the football. And, you know, the Tigers maybe kind of likes that because we've been wanting the football. We're going to be going left to right if you're looking at your radio at home, or you can if you're looking at TV, you know that we're going to be going left to right. So appreciate Miss Patricia Gillian Roberts and also Miss Evelyn Williams out there. You might know this guy here, Ryan Barksdale, out there checking in with us. Miss Glenda Wright, Tammy Paul's checking in. Brother Mitch Nether, I'm over in Kuwait tonight. Greg Kane, thank you so much, Greg Crane. And looking and sounding great from all the way over in Kuwait tonight. So, Mitch, we appreciate you, Brother Mitch, and all the folks that are over there. Tigers are getting ready to come out here in a minute. Do me a favor. All you people that's watching now, I'll forget to tell you later, maybe. Share this link on your Facebook so the people that you've got on your Facebook page will know about it, and we'll reach even more and more people, the folks that are that like to be here tonight. Ladies and gentlemen, the Red Bay Tigers are about ready. Keith, I'm going to say here come the Tigers here in just a second, and here they come. You've got the Red Bay Tiger Football Network. Hello, everybody. Jack Ivey, Keith Kennedy, Byron Helms, and Denise Ivey back in Control Center. We're live at Fred Bostic Jr. Memorial Stadium in Red Bay, Alabama. The Tigers in a must-win situation here tonight. We're looking at postseason. Tigers have struggled this year. 3-3 on the season. Have lost to Mars Hill. Not good. A loss to Carbon Heights. They also lost to Lamar County. Now, only a couple of those were division losses, but this is a big region game tonight, and of course we got to go to Sullivan next week, and that's going to be a very tough task. Still got Phil Campbell coming up as well, but we need to win this ball game and Phil Campbell for sure to get in the playoffs, don't you think?
That's right, and we've dug ourselves in a hole here, so we're going to have to fight out of it, but we can do it.
No
we
doubt about it. Red Bay Tigers facing a pretty good ball club. Sheffield, they're not quite as good as it was last year. They lost that quarterback and big defensive back. He went up to Memphis, and I'm sure they're missing him. But, Keith, they got skilled players all over the field. They got a lot of speed, and we're going to have to really, really, really watch it close, them getting to the outside.
Be disciplined. Stay at home, be disciplined. Tackle, get those shoulder pads on them, and lock up.
Thank you, folks, that are sharing. We really appreciate you very much. We're ready for the kickoff. This is live coverage of Red Bay Tiger football. Tigers going left to right. There's the kickoff. Little pooch kick to the 23-yard line. Tigers backtrack all the way back to the 15. Not for sure why. They're going to get us all the way back at the 10-yard line. And I believe we're going to lose our yardage all the way back to the 10-yard line, Keith.
Yeah, I don't.
We had it at the 23, and we started backtracking a little bit. I'm sure looking to maybe try to get some blocks. And lost all the way back to the 10-yard line.
I don't know if we had a right return or what, but we lost 13 yards there. But we got first and goal on the team.
Tigers are ringing up. They're going to have Luke Rooker going over to the left side, Max Bullen over there as well. And, Keith, they've got number 5. You might know that Cam McKinney moved to number 5 on instead of 56, and they've got him blocking back there. We're going to run that ball right side, and not much running room there at all. Just barely made it back to the line of scrimmage,
yeah,
Keith.
Yeah, we just they were slanting to the sort of toward the center, and when we say slant, they just instead of going straight ahead, they're turning right or left, and the two inside guys was turning right and right into the play. So we got 2nd and 10.
Appreciate Movie Mania on the Golden Road. New releases only 99 cents a night. Tigers. Going to run that ball to the left side, and we got a flag as the Tigers stay on up to about the 18-yard line.
They're going to get us for holding, I think. We got it up to the 29-yard line.
19?
I don't know. I don't think it's holding. Hold on. Personal foul. Face mask.
Oh, man, that's against them. So it kind of, come into place. You'd expect maybe them to throw a hole the way the guy done it. But
the guy that lines up right behind the right in the middle of the field where, he's watching those guards and tackles and just right where, like you said, they call holding. But apparently they got their hands up in our face mask. So that's 15 yards.
So 15 yards from the end of the run. On top of that, we got it out to the 19. So that's going to move it all the way out to about the 34-yard line. Yeah. Is that right? He's trying to figure out. Keith, the guys that called the game last week, and I'm not saying they called a bad game, but their biggest weakness was spotting the ball.
Yeah, I noticed that in replay. Like when somebody's knocked out of bounds, they got to leave that ball over there and bring the chains across to measure. They don't go out to send midfield and measure.
Well, that's what they did all night long.
That's not right.
First and 10, Tigers are on 34-yard line. Quarterback in the shotgun, hands off to the right side, up to the 35, to the 39-yard line. That's Aaron Lewis running the football for the Tigers. We'll have second down and 10.
What about second down 5?
Second down 5. I'm glad you corrected me. Second and 5.
I watch those replays naturally, I wonder why I say some of the things I say. I call some of these names the way I call them. Where in the world I get them?
39-yard line. The Tigers going to hand it off to the right side. And, boy, they're going to meet us in the hole and throw us for loss. Aaron Louie will be stopped at the 38-yard line. So now it's going to be third down.
And 6.
And 6 yards to go for the first down. Appreciate BJL Rod Walters down at BJ's Hair Accessory, 662-676-4445. 28 years experience. And I'll tell you what, she does a wonderful job down at BJ's Hair Accessories. Tigers bringing it up, third down, 6. Kobe Bragwell, your quarterback, fakes it, and he's going to roll out to the left, looking downfield, turns and gets a pass. Beautiful catch down at the 45-yard line, and down is Max Bullen. And Keith, he finally got turned around, squared up to be able to get a good throw on it.
Yeah,
and
we got to the 44-yard line, so that was from the 39-yard line down to the.
So the Tigers will have it first and 10 at their 44-yard line. Was that about a 16-yard toss?
Yeah, 16.
Shotgun. This time they're going to hand it off right in the middle, breaking it, flag on the play, down to the 40-yard line. This is Max Bullen. And Max got it to the 39, but
that's where it's holding, too.
So we're waiting on the official here. Byron's got us a good shot of it there, and the official is going to get us for chop blocking.
Golly.
So that will be a penalty against the Red Bay Tigers. We made it down to their 44-yard line.
Going back 15.
That's a major penalty.
Yeah, it's going to be
shot
first
blocking.
Yeah, it'll be first and 25. That's a real questionable call there because, you know, what did they say when you engaged with the guy up top, somebody can't come along and cut his knee. But a lot of times those guys are falling and stumbling and that's not what the intent is, but they get called for it.
So the Tigers first down and long, about 25 to go. Here comes Max, and, they string that one out, and we did not. Max had that long run. You know, you saw that the other night on your replay. Other than that particular play, they did a wonderful job. I'm talking about Lamar County stringing that jet sweep out, and we didn't get any positive yards on several plays. Matter of fact, we lost yards on several plays as we did that one there, Keith. We got to get all the way down to the 34-yard line, but it is second down, and we're at our own 39-yard line.
Yeah, it's 27, second and 27.
How many plays we got for 27 yards? We're fixing to find out. We're going to go to the left side, running the football, and the Tigers turn it in 45 up to the 50, knocked out of bounds. That's Kobe running that ball,
yeah,
Mr. King. Good job, Kobe. Still going to be second down.
About 16 yards. He picked up 11 then.
So
third down. 16.
Third down, 16 yards to go. Red Bay Tiger football tonight live on WRMG TV 12 and also television 97. A lot of folks watching us online. Remember, let your friends and neighbors know that Red Bay Tiger football is on Facebook Live tonight. We're going to toss it up. Got Kobe King out here. Get a block down to the 45, and he's going to be thrown out of bounds at about the 43-yard line. So we're going to be less than 10, about 9 yards to go. Fourth down and 9, Tigers in punt formation. Hayden Murray will be doing the punt. They got number 6 back to receive this punt, David Boutwell. Let's see how Hayden does. No rush at all. And there's the punt. And it takes a little Tiger bounce down to the 16-yard line. So no return. Sheffield will take over first and 10 at their own 16-yard line. Hey, tonight's game, of course, no score in the game. We're live in Red Bay. We got 7:27 to go. First quarter of today's game brought to you by Spark Contracting. We take care of all your building needs, whether it be building your new home, doing a little remodeling, maybe doing some seamless gutters, maybe some siding, metal roofing, concrete work. Call Jamie Sparks, 662-523-8588. Also on a broadcast tonight is McKinney RV Sales and Service. Also, Dr. Stephen Ray's Family Dentistry since 1993. And here's the first play. They're going to fake it. Quarterback's going to pull it down. He's got it to the 20, up to the 25-yard line.
Nearly 10 yards. Picked up 9. Be second one. That was just a fake to end around, or and quarterback just run a draw up the middle.
Quarterback with two receivers to the right, one to the left, one in the slot to the right side. Sheffield and Red Bay no score in the ball game. Must win game for the Tigers here tonight. He is going to hand this one off, and he's up to about the 23-yard line, falling forward, and the Tigers finally get him down, Keith.
Yeah, he just just a little playoff over guard, and we stacked it up about for about a 3-yard gain, and so he pushed the pile up about another for another yard, so they're going to be at the 29-yard line, first and 10.
No score in the ball game. We're live on WRMG TV 12, TV 97, also on WRMGRadio.com. We're Facebook Live at it tonight on WRMG Live, and they move a little early. Well, not a little early, a lot early.
That's undeniable right there. He
didn't even try to deny being offside there, did he?
No, he was ready to go.
Appreciate Miss Lisa Jackson out there, Miss Kay Newell and their family, O'Fair and Criddle, Chloe Mills out there tonight, Selena Cantrell, Kay Thompson joined us down in Union County, Mississippi, Miss Barbara Harris, Miss Donna Purser out there, Miss Pat Lindsay, and here's Sheffield on the run to the right side over the 25, 26-yard line before the blue jerseys.
Yeah, that was Mr. Cam McKinney over there and Logan Scott over there.
Miss Teresa Fears out there. I told you about Donna Weatherford. What about Lauren Gober? Philip Rogers out there tonight checking us out. And we'd love to hear from you. Get on there and let us know if you're watching and how it looks wherever you're at tonight. Sheffield lost a couple of yards on that one. It'll be second down and 12. Quarterback in the shotgun. Two receivers right, one left. This time he's going to hand that ball coming to the left side. Cuts it up to the 30, 35, to the 40. Cuts it back, and he may take it all the way. He's down to the 40. He's down to the 20-yard line now, 10, and he's into the end zone for a touchdown. I'm scanning, and Keith, I do not see any flags on the field.
No.
And that is going to be a touchdown run.
Just a little counterplay, and just cut it back against the grain, and no pursuit.
That's Cedric Carroll Jr. running the football there. And that'll put Sheffield up by a score of 6-0 on a long run there. Keith, that wasn't too far from about 75 yards, was it?
It was, it was pretty real close, yeah.
Live coverage of Red Bay Tiger football tonight and kind of a must-win game here tonight. The extra point up by number 14 is up. It is good. So Sheffield leads by a score of 7-0. That touchdown comes with 5:28 to go in the first quarter. 5:28 to go in the first quarter. It is the Red Bay Tigers trailing Sheffield by a score of 7-0. So the Tigers will get their second opportunity of it in just a minute. We're live tonight. Don't forget we got the Red Bay and also the band from Sheffield with us tonight. Not a huge crowd from Sheffield over tonight, but they got their band with them and several fans that came over, but just not a huge crowd. But I will say this, the Tigers had a huge crowd down at Lamar County at the game down there. Big shout out tonight to Tiny Tigers Pre-K. That's Angeline Chambly there. She takes them 18 months to 4 years. She's got a state pre-K class, got a before and after school, got a summer program. She's open 5:30 in the morning till 5:30 in the afternoon, 356-8736. Also, the Banner Tire Store, 8320 Fairview Banner Road, New News Tires. They carry all different kinds of tires, including your Duck Commander tires. They fix those tractor flats. Jason Parker is the manager there, 662-676-2177. Also want to say hello to Dr. Jim Neighbors, just after the Neighbors Clinic. The city of Red Bay, the mayor and the council, and also Big Star of Red Bay. There's a kickoff, pooch kick. This time the Tigers get it at about the 25, and we're going to lose it back to about the 21.
I don't know what we're trying to do.
That was Aaron Louie on it, and instead of taking straight up the field, Aaron wants to bring that ball back to the home side, and he probably lost about 5 yards backtracking on that particular play.
I mean, golly, give me a break. Catch it over on the sideline on the left and trying to get to the right, and it's on the 20-yard line. Take that ball and go north and south, son.
Head toward the locker room, right?
That's it.
Left to right, the Red Bay Tigers trailing 7-0. Appreciate Randy Ivey checking in with us, and also Jamie Scott. Doug Lyles checking in with us out in Tulsa, Oklahoma. Red Bay Tigers, Kobe King. Kobe's got a good run over there, over the 25, up to about the 28-yard line.
Yeah, pick up about 7 yards then. Way to go, buddy. If you watch him, Jack, when he gets out there, he's got that head on a swivel. He's looking to see if maybe he needs to cut it back or go outside, and he picked up 7 yards. Good run.
Red Bay Tiger football tonight brought to you by H&R Block of Red Bay, Iuka, Fulton, by Franklin Electric. Also, thank Big Star of Red Bay. We told you about Redmont Pharmacy, Mr. J.C. Weeks and the staff. Also, CBNS Bank, Mary Ellen Allen and the crew. And also, Grace Long Real Estate. Second down and three, the Tigers at about the 27. Quarterback back to pass, floats it out to the Red Bay Tiger 35-yard line. Max Mullen Jr. has got a first down for the Red Bay Tigers. They're going to place it at about the 36, Keith.
He threw a late flag there. I don't know what it's about.
On the sideline right there?
Out there in the middle of the field. It was a late flag. It was.
So they're talking it over. We want to see what this one's all about. We got an ineligible receiver downfield. Coach is wanting to know who was the ineligible person downfield. So the Tigers going to lose that first down, and now they're going to be back at about the 23-yard line.
Second down and eight.
Second down, 8 yards to go. Jack Ivey, Keith Kennedy, Byron Helms live here in Red Bay. We got, of course, Denise back at Control Center. We're glad you could join us on our broadcast here tonight. Big play here. The Tigers are down 7-0 in the first quarter with 4:30 to go in the first quarter. This time going to hand it off. No running room that time, maybe to the 24-yard line. Keith, you get a ball control team like we had against Vernon down at Lamar County High School down there. I'm thinking third quarter, we didn't get but one series. You know, you're not guaranteed how many times you're going to get the ball. And
we
got it one time, I think, in the third quarter down there.
We're just not getting any push off our line. Of course, Sheffield's got some pretty hefty-looking young men there on that front three, and we're not getting them off the line of scrimmage.
Mr. Don Spencer out there. I see Miss Judy Bolton out there and Mr. Billy out there tonight. And we got a fumble on the play, and I believe Sheffield has recovered it back at the 20-yard line. And that is going to be the case. So I got you bad news. Sheffield has recovered the fumble, and they're going to get the football. They're going to mark it at the 21-yard line. Billy and Judy down in Dothan, Alabama, checking us out tonight.
This game isn't starting off like we needed to.
We're going to have to make a stop right here. They got first down and 10 of the Tiger 21-yard line. Live coverage here on the Ivy Broadcasting Company, brought to you by some really, really great sponsors we'll be telling you about all night long, including Davis Ford in Fulton. Quarterback back to pass. He's number two. Pass over the middle. He's got a receiver. and it is incomplete. He was open. We just put a hit on him.
Well, the quarterback was late getting the ball there. He was wide open, and it gave us time to get over there. And
who hit him?
Kobe Bragwell.
Kobe Bragwell put a lick on him.
So that makes it second and 10 from the 21. Boy, he was open.
Quarterback this time in the shotgun. We'll look over. Play from the side coming in from Sheffield. They're going to check it off here at the line. Second down and 10 at the 21. Quarterback pulled it down. He's going to run it right up the
middle.
And he breaks a tackle.
Fumbled.
He fumbled it down at the inside the 10-yard line. I'm not for sure who's got it. There's a big scramble. That possession could change down to the bottom of this stack. Still going to be
Sheffield's ball.
And they got a first down on that one.
Yeah.
Quarterback just faked the handoff, and the quarterback ran it in.
Yeah, it's just poor tackling on our defense. They just aren't trying to arm tackle. They're not getting any shoulder pads on it. We just ain't got any life, Jack. Life at all.
Appreciate Red Bay Rentals now leasing. That's, of course, Mr. Johnny Weatherford, 256-668-0039. First and 10, or first and goal, I should say, just inside the 10. Quarterback hands it off to 21, and he's down to about the 5 or 6 yard line.
Yeah, it's going to be just short of the 5.
Second down and goal.
Yeah, tackle over there by Logan Scott and Mr. Engel.
Live coverage here on the Ivy Broadcasting Company, and Red Bay Tigers already down 7-0, 2:41 to go first quarter. Sheffield leads 7-0, and Sheffield threatening again. They're going to hand it off 21. He's inside the 5.
He's down about the 2.
2-yard line. It'll be third down and goal. Boy, we got to stack it up down there, I'm telling you.
They got it right on the 2-yard line.
Jeff Hill still in the shotgun here. Third and goal from about the 2. The quarterback pulls it down, and he's going to be short.
He's
the
on
goal
the,
line.
He's about the one. Inside the 1.
So it'll be fourth down and goal.
Yeah. That's Mr. Joseph Newell, number 77, on that tackle. It's inside the 1. It's about a half a yard.
Tigers.
Look here.
Bringing in number 78. And Sheffield is going to go for it right here on fourth down and goal just inside the 1-yard line. They hand it off, and the Tigers hit him in the backfield, and his second effort gets him into the end zone.
Again, you got to wrap those arms up, those good running backs. You can't wing them. You got to wrap them up.
So the Red Bay Tigers now are down 13-0. So they'll try the extra point right here. We're live tonight in Red Bay. Do me a favor, if you're checking out our broadcast here tonight, make sure you share it so some more friends, Mr. Roman Lynch, Joe Tester out there, Brother Bob Massey out there checking us out tonight. And the extra point's up. Looks good. It is. It's 14-0, Sheffield, and we got a minute and 51 seconds to go in the first quarter. So the Tigers have dug them a big hole to get out of here tonight.
Yeah, this is just not what we needed.
No question. Today's game brought to you by Consider the Lilies, Angie and Ted LeMay. We got local honey for sale, new arrivals just in, 2 styles of essential oil diffusers. And they also got our newest addition to the essential oil line. It's white grapefruit. Come check them out. Once again, Consider the Lilies, 356-8313. Also, Bunny Gray at Davis Realty. If you need to buy or sell a home, make sure you call Miss Bunny, 256-460-8064. Also, that great-tasting Carl Lewis sausage by Gary Armstrong. It does all your Dozier backhoe work. If you need dirt move, call Gary, 256-810-4596. Also, want to thank 4th Street Grill and Steakhouse, Lori and Brent Collum, your owners there, 356-2226. They're open Tuesday through Thursday, 10:30 to 9. Friday and Saturday, 10:30 to 10. And on Sunday, 10:30 to 9. You can call them once again, 356-2226. They do catering like nobody else. 4th Street Grill and Steakhouse. Kickoff time for Sheffield. And Sheffield pooches this one to the right side, and we're going to get it on the 21-yard line. Fumbles it, and he picks it up at the 25, up to the 30, breaks it out to the 40, down to the sideline, and he's going to go all the way. Somebody's going to try to chase him down. He's at the 20. He's at the 10. He is tackled at the 1-yard line, or maybe the 2. Keith, he caught the football, ran about 2 or 3 steps and dropped it and picked it up, and you said, oh, no.
And if I'm glad we don't have replay. He was on his knee when he picked that ball up.
Oh, man. We won't bring that up, Will.
No. And I'm glad we don't have replay.
They caught him at about the 2-yard line. It'll be first down and goal for the Tigers. And once again, we're live tonight on WRMG. Thanks to Ronnie Cook, your Modern Woodman agent, serving Belmont and Red Bay and the surrounding area, 662-423-8477. Also, the Red Bay Hospital on a broadcast tonight. Miss Shirley, Sherry Jolly and all the staff, thank you so much. Also, Triple D's Bucket Service. Barney Brandon and Dusta Dick, they take care of all your high-reach needs. We're going to hand off Louie. Louie, right side, walks into the end zone for the touchdown. Well, just what the doc ordered, and that was a quick touchdown, and we get it. This touchdown happens with a minute 30 to go, and let's see if we can pick up that Red Bay Tiger marching band. And the Red Bay Tigers are going to go for 2. They're going to hand it off left side. Louie stood up and not going to be able to get it in there. We had all the power to the left side. That's exactly which way we went. And they had it played nicely. And they keep us out of the end zone for the 2-point conversion. And we got a 14-6 ball game. 14-6 ball game. Sheffield leading. Well, I thought Joe Tester said he was going to be here tonight. He said he's home watching via Facebook page. So sorry I couldn't be there. Y'all sounding good, loud and clear. Joe's watching it on TV. Old Randy Pike out there. And Keith, you down there right now?
I'm down here.
I want to say condolences to some great friends of everybody in Red Bay, Alabama. Of course, the Thatcher family. And, of course, Miss Jerry and his family. I tell you what, they had Mark's funeral today in Red Bay, and, of course, Miss Judy and all the family. I tell you what, that was a sad, sad situation, and Mark's definitely going to be missed, but it's a sad time.
Yeah, those guys, young men, grew up right down the street from us, and I watched them grow up, and I know Michael and Matthew, the oldest one and the youngest one, a little better than I knew Mark, but Mark, he was such a humble guy from way, way back. He just so humble. And, you know, the good Lord, he got a good one when he picked him. And so,
no doubt.
So he we're going to miss him. And I know his mom and dad. And I visited with him some. And those brothers going to miss him. But he's in a good place.
No doubt about it. Jerry said that's the only way they could make it through it is knowing, you know, where he's at. And, of course, he said, I know Mark wouldn't want me to – make sure that you know that that's where he wants you to be to see him again someday. So the boys and dad did a good job at the funeral today in Red Bay. And, of course, appreciate First Baptist Church. They actually streamed it live so the folks down in Florida could watch it. And a lot of local folks watched it as too. And we appreciate them doing that so the families down in Florida could also see it that couldn't make the trip. So condolences once again to Jerry and Miss Judy and, of course, Michael and Matthew and, of course, Miss Sabrina, his wife, the family. I tell you what, we're thinking and praying for y'all very much.
That's right. That's right. We love you.
You know, no doubt about it. Well, that was offsides against the Tigers. We're going to have to kick off at the 35-yard line. And this time the kickoff goes down to the 26. They're back to the 30, 35, up to the 40. We missed 2 or 3 tackles. They break it outside to the 50. Down to the 40-yard line, down to the 30. Are we going to be able to catch him? I'm not for sure. 5, touchdown. You have got to be kidding. A 65-yard or so touchdown return on the kickoff. We had 2 or 3 guys that I thought had an angle and could not make the play to Sheffield. gets that 6 points back quick. It's 20-6 Sheffield as Sheffield takes the Red Bay kickoff back for the touchdown. So Sheffield has been very successful kicking their extra points tonight, and they're going to try to kick it again right here. And the extra point, it is up. It is good. It's 21-6, and we've had three touchdowns already in the first quarter for Sheffield. They lead 21. Red Bay's had one touchdown. So with a minute 15 to go in the first quarter, it's the Red Bay Tigers trailing Sheffield by a score of 21-6. See, old Mr. Tommy Cox is out there checking us out tonight.
All right.
You know, I could eat a little peanut brittle, couldn't you?
I'm telling you. He's on to what else he can do.
Make some good brownies.
He can make some good of those oatmeal cookies, chocolate oatmeal. He can make some good ones of those.
I could eat. Have you ever eaten any of his smoked bologna?
Yeah. Well, you know he's my neighbor.
Oh. No wonder he ain't been bringing me none lately. You've been probably down there swiping it from
him. Yeah. I said, don't bring it to Jack. Just drop it off over here at your neighbors.
Appreciate Paige Clearing. Best wishes to Joel, Caroline, and Jody Paige tonight, along with the Red Bay Gas and Water. Also, Mr. Mike Schubert, your hometown school board member, by Sunshine Meals, makers of that great cat food and dog food, by Chuck Barber, and all the staff at Cash and Thermoplastics, your hometown Piggly Wiggly in Belmont, Red Bay, and Iuka, on that Piggly Wiggly daily menu. Also, Mike Engel at Engel Farms. Don't forget to have all your poultry house cleanouts. It's Mike Engel, 256-668-0775. Tigers on the return this time out to about the 33-yard line. That's Kobe King on the return, and the Tigers will take over first and 10 at that point. Appreciate old Johnny Stockton checking in with us. Johnny, I think maybe down about South Hill. Got Mr. Benny Gray over in Iuka, and Jade Pounds out there watching tonight. Do me a favor. The audience is gradually climbing as folks realize that we are streaming the game live tonight. We've already said, folks that said it looks good. I'd like to know about the audio, the quality of the audio. Had just a tiny little buzz a couple of weeks ago, but you didn't really notice it while the game was going on. You didn't notice it, but I think I got that little issue straightened out. But do me a favor, let me know how it sounds as well and where you're watching the game tonight. A lot of you, I don't know for sure where you're at, but we'd love to hear from you and let us know. The Tigers on the quarterback keeper here over the 35 up to the 37-yard line. That's Kobe Bragwell running the football, and we're late in the first quarter, 56 seconds to go. Greg Scott said it's good. Daniel Garrison said it's good. Miss Lisa Jackson's good. Got old Logan Keneal out there checking us out tonight. Gail Rooker said it sounds good, so we appreciate you being with us. Live coverage of Red Bay football tonight. Second down and 5 after the Bragwell pickup of 5 yards. Jack Ivey, Keith Kennedy here along with Byron Hillams. And their little swing pass out to the left. And Max Bullen is going to be awful close to the first down marker with a little extra effort over there, Keith. And they're going to say he made it to about the 41-yard line, and he's going to be
about
awful
a yard
close.
Yeah.
It's going to be a little short.
Yeah. Just no, they go first down. First down.
Now they decided to first down.
Yeah, just a little flare out there, and Max picked his way there and picked up a first down.
Keith, down at Lamar County the other night, this guy on this side had it marked. They went out there and marked it, and I promise you, from where he,
I saw that.
Remember where they had it marked on the chain?
Missed it about a yard. Didn't
Yeah. And they finally got it straightened out, and I said, oh, my goodness. First down, 10 Tigers on 42-yard line. Quarterback's going to pull it down again. That's Bragwell. Bragwell, good running room to the 50. He's got another first down down to the 46-yard line. First quarter about to come to a close here. Only 2 seconds to go. 21-6 Sheffield. 21-6 Sheffield. I asked you earlier to share this link so other folks would know about it. And we've got a lot of new folks watching right now. So if you've not shared this on your Facebook page so more and more people can watch into the first quarter, do that right now while we got a little break. Anybody that's watching, share this. Just go down to the bottom of the page and share it. Good to hear from Mr. Kelly Moore out there tonight, Greg Burleson, Miss Kendra James out there checking us out tonight, Caleb Burroughs out there watching. So share it for us right now, and we surely would appreciate it. There's the Red Bay Tiger cheerleaders performing down below. Well, they moved down here a little closer. They moved way down, and we couldn't even see them down there. Appreciate Community Spirit Bank, your hometown bank with hometown solutions. Mr. Brad Bolton, Mr. Billy, and all the staff. Boy, they've been around for a long time doing it right since 1908, 356-4445. Also want to thank the Cardinal Drive-In on the Golden Road, 356-2358. Thank you, Miss Stephanie and Denise. Alpha Insurance Agent, Mr. John Cook. Also, Dr. Fabianchi at the Medical Clinic of Red Bay, 356-9511. Stadium Pros with Keith Kennedy and Alton Barksdale on our broadcast. Also want to thank Baytree Gift Company, your complete gift headquarters, and also Baby Registry as well. They got that Etta B. Pottery from down in Etta, Mississippi. Got the fingerprint from Pontotoc and much, much more. They are your complete gift headquarters. If you want to shop at a place that's owned by the folks right there in Red Bay, Alabama, we highly recommend Lindsay, Jane, Lori, and the staff at Baytree Gift Company. Quarterback rolling out to the right, looks and throws, and they're going to say incomplete down at the 39-yard line. Intended for Rooker.
Yeah, be second and 10. He was open. He just underthrew him a little bit there. But I was glad to see us throw him first down. That's a plus, I think.
Oh, Kelly said the audio is great. Ain't no telling where Kelly's at tonight.
He's here.
Is he?
He's in Red Bay.
Awesome. Well, the Tigers got second down and 10. We're at their 45-yard line. Folks, we trail 21-6 in a must-win game for the Tigers here tonight. We're going to hand it off. Kobe King, they barrel him up. He's going to lose a couple of yards. They're going to give him to the 47. So he loses two. It's going to be third down and 12.
Yeah, they jump in that play right there. We're going to have to come up with something new. You know something, Jack, that I think would work is, you know, we run that stretch play with Max.
Right.
I'm thinking if we had a reverse, somebody coming back the other direction.
Oh, my goodness.
I think we might have something to work on.
You ain't put that play in tonight, Eddie.
No, that's just you and me talking.
Third down and 12 yards to go for the first down. This time we're going to bring it to Max. He's going to turn it in. Not much room there on third and 12. Pretty conservative play right here. And we're going to have fourth down and about 9 to go for the first down. Remember, folks, the more folks we get on here watching, it makes me a lot more happier. And I'm telling you, Keith, they don't realize how much extra trouble it is to get all this extra equipment up here to be able to stream it to you. Now, we're not just holding up a cell phone and going Facebook Live like most people do. We're using our cameras, our equipment, some special equipment we had to purchase to make it look more presentable, and it's a lot of trouble, and we need you to be watching, and that makes us happy that we go to all that extra trouble and expense. There's a punt. We're going to get him by the 16-yard line. Yeah. Alex Kennedy, great coverage downfield, Keith.
Yeah, made a good tackle there. We're going to start on about the 15, 16-yard line.
Got old Josh Pfeiffer out there tonight, Tommy J. Timms, Randy Lowry out there. Hey, Randy. Also, Josh Pfeiffer, what about Miss Barbara Cashin out there watching tonight?
All right. Hey, Miss Barbara.
So y'all keep sharing it. Miss Barbara knows how to share that.
Do you know, can you tell where Randy Lowry is?
It doesn't say, but we'll ask him. Randy, where you at tonight?
Yeah, tell us where he is.
First down and 10, Sheffield. They lead the Tigers 21-6 there at their own about 15-and-a-half-yard line. Quarterback in the shotgun. They're going to hand that ball and run it to the left side. That's 21 again. He's over the 20 to the 22-yard line.
Yeah.
Keith, Mr. Engel there.
Yeah, they just knocking us off the ball over there, you know. They just pick up 6 yards there on first down.
Engel and Bragwell on the stop over there for the Tigers. Randy is in Chicago.
Chicago.
You ask where he's at? Boy, he tells us in a hurry. Randy, we miss you.
Yes, sir. We need you.
Second down and about 4 to go for the Sheffield Bulldogs. Lanier Cheatham, the quarterback, going to hand it off again. The Tigers, Logan Scott, one of the guys there early to get him for basically no gain.
Yeah.
Who else is down there? Engel?
Engel and Mr. Newell. It'll be third down and 3.
Oh, Joseph. Miss Barbara Cashin said it's looking great. There's old Shane McNeil out there. We got Billy Stidham checking in from Naples, Florida tonight.
Oh, my gracious.
Third down and 3. Red Bay Tigers trailing 21-6. We need a stop here big time. Quarterback faked it. He's going to run it, and he has got a first down over the 25 up to the 27-yard line. So Cheatham gets the first down for the – we got Jamie Scott out there checking in with us. Miss Twyla Glenn Graham out there tonight. We got 9:07 to go. In the second quarter, Sheffield 21. The Red Bay Tigers are 6. We're live tonight at Fred Bostick Jr. Memorial Stadium in Red Bay. We'll be in Sulligent tomorrow night. A little swing pass to the right side. Good play by the Tigers. Finally get him down. And Keith, good play by your number 10 right there, Mr. Jalen Vincent.
Yes, sir. He's going to be a player.
I got to ask you a question. Did you – you weren't there in person, but you watched it back. What about that interception that he got? Did you remember seeing that on the replay?
Yes.
What now? Stride for stride or whatever, and the ball got tipped up and it come right down his hands. It was a beautiful interception.
All right. Second down and 12 there. Yeah.
So that play lost two.
Yeah.
Quarterback in the shotgun. That's Cheatham. Got two receivers to the left side, one to the right, one in a slot over on the left side. Tigers, four down linemen. And they're going to hand it off and run it to the left side. This is number 6, and the Tigers there to make a good play over there.
Who that's made Alex. That's Alex. That boy Alex. He got in there and made a play, picked up 1 yard. It's going to be third down 11.
Candy Cantrell out there says, thanks, Jack. We're in Decatur, Illinois, and I'm getting to watch my nephews play for the first time this year.
All right.
And Caleb Collins out there watching. We could use them Collins boys, too.
Oh, yeah, them Collins boys. We call some games them they play. Sure do.
No, hey, those Collins, they're trying to get us some future football players.
We need to hurry up and get them.
I know it. Third down and 11. I want to be calling it, maybe not in a wheelchair, but if I have to, I will. Quarterback pulls this one down, and he's up to the 35-40, over to the 42, maybe to the 44-yard line, where they're going to end up giving him. No, they may back it up a little bit.
Well, you know, that's just Max Bullens and Alex both tried winging him, and he just run right through them. They had him for about a 5-yard gain, and you got to lock up, guys. You got to lock up. You just don't run into them. You tackle them.
Oh, Joe Tester said his ex-coach Jimmy Mayfield is watching, but he said he gave him a chance to be on the team back in 1980. He wasn't that good, but we give him a shout-out anyway. So, Coach, one of your former players, Mr. Joe Tester, giving you a big shout-out tonight. Right. There's a running play. No running room. The Tigers are there.
Yeah, that's Mr. Max Bullen on the bottom. He grabbed on that time. He locked on. So, good play, Max. It's second down 11. You just when those guys, these guys have, they keep those legs moving and they're got lot pretty good agility and you just gotta when you hit them you gotta lock up.
No doubt about it. We're live here tonight on WRMG TV 12 and also Television 97. Running play to the left side over the 45 to the 50. They're going to be looking at fourth down and about 4. So unless he had already switched it over, I guess he, they moved that doggone thing to third down before their even play was over. So I looked over and it said third. So it's got to be fourth down, but they had already moved it
it's third down.
Third and six to go. You're right. Third down 4. They're at the 50-yard line. Quarterback in the shotgun. They're going to check it off of the line. They look over to the home sideline. Quarterback's going to pull this one down, and he is going to be short of the first down by about a yard or two. I see Mr. Engel down there.
Yeah, he's the one that stopped him. Yes, sir. Good play. Mr. Newell, good play, guys. It's going to be fourth and 2. Fourth and 1. I can't believe they're going to punt.
You wouldn't, would you?
No, sir.
They lead Red Bay 21-6. We're going to send Kobe Bragwell back. They got fourth down and a yard to go. They're at the Red Bay Tiger 47-yard line. And the Tigers got some pretty good pressure on. Get off a pretty good punt. We're going to call for the fair catch down at about the 15-yard line. So we'll put it in play first down and 10. Big shout out to all of our great sponsors tonight, including Dr. Ralph Nick's Family Dentistry, located behind the post office, 356-8641. By Tiffin Motor Homes, featuring Allegro, Fastway Car Wash, Miss Ann Vincent out on Highway 19, the Deaton Funeral Home of Red Bay and Belmont. By Albin Mason Construction Company, 662-660-3355. Also, Dickey Spark CPA, that number in Red Bay, 356-9375. Also, Ronald Thorne, your good neighbor insurance agent, now writing insurance in Mississippi from his Red Bay office, located on Main Street, Red Bay, 356-4459. He's waited 38 years, and he's excited about having some additional customers right next door. So congratulations, Mr. Ronald Thorne. Boy, I tell you what, we need to drive big time. The Tiger's going to hand it off to Louie. Louie breaks a tackle over to the 15, maybe up to the 17. It'll be second down, Tigers, with 4:56 clock running. Sheffield leads 21-6. Key.
Yeah, we just we've given up big plays, and Jack, it just doesn't like we're playing with any emotions. We just like we're going through the motions, and
right.
Well, you got to have a little passion about yourself when you play this game, and we just don't act like we got it.
Tigers this time on the quarterback keeper. He breaks a little tackle there and up to the 30-yard line. He's got – or up to the 20-yard line. He's going to be – they're going to say he's about the 19. So he's going to be about, what, four short, maybe
five? Well, he's right on the 20. He's about – he's about a long four or short five. We haven't established anything tonight offensively as far as getting us a drive going.
They're going to move the tight end over on the right side. That's Cam McKinney, the quarterback in the shotgun. Third down about four and a half. We're going to Kobe King to the right. Kobe turns that corner. He's got a first down and more over the 25 to the 30-yard line. Let's see where they got him out of bounds. They might have got him a little bit short of that.
Got him about about to 28.
So it will be first down, Red Bay Tigers. You know, I don't know where he's checked in with us tonight. I see Miss Valerie Morrow's out there tonight, Mr. Leroy Dean. I don't know where Danny Latham has checked in with us out there tonight.
What about our brother Ned?
They're watching over in Kuwait.
Hello, guys.
First down and 10, Red Bay Tigers at about the 27. Tigers rolling out to the left. There's a pass over the middle, and that's going to be almost intercepted.
Ooh-wee.
Kobe King turned into a defender. Number 17 had it right in his hand. I mean, it was thrown right to him. And that was a dangerous one right there.
It's tough to roll to the left and throw it when you're a right-handed quarterback. They've got us linemen downfield again.
So we got another flag against the Tigers.
It's going to be
first down and about
15.
First down at about 15 for the Red Bay Tigers. We're live tonight in Red Bay. Not a good night for the Tigers so far. We're down 21-6 with 3:29 to go. Now, I will tell you this, Sheffield's going to get the ball first to start the second half, so kind of important for us to get this ball on down the field and maybe get on the scoreboard again tonight before this one is over. Quarterback back to pass. He looks for Rooker. Rooker turns that ball back in over the 30 to the 33-yard line. Good play there by the Red Bay Tigers. Smith in on the stop. Red Bay Tigers will have about 5 yards to go.
Yes.
Mr. Humphreys into the ball game for the Red Bay Tigers at number 17. We got a hurry. Second down and five. We're on our own 33-yard line. We're going to bring Rooker to the right. Humphreys and looks like Bullen over to the right side. Quarterback rolling out this time. The pass back to the left, right through the hands of number 22, Aaron Louie,
yep,
up at about the 34-yard line.
Jack, just see us. We're just walking around. We just not got any energy. We just like we're going through the motions. And guys, we got to pick it up.
That'll get you beat.
Yeah, we've got to pick it up. Third and five.
Third down and five for the Red Bay Tigers. They're going to go to Max Bullen to the right. Come on, Max, turn that ball in. Get upfield. Max lowers that head. He's going to be short of the first down, I believe. We're going to see exactly what kind of shot we get right here.
We're close.
It's going to be real close.
First down.
They're going to give it to us. First down. First down. Boy, that was big one. First down, Tigers with 2:34 to go, 21-6, Sheffield leading. Appreciate the Predator Pest Control, Mr. Clay and Ted Weatherford, Eddie Deaton. Thank you, guys. Wicked Marinero, Melissa, and Teddy Humphreys there serving great pizza, of course, in the old Mr. J's location. Got all those old recipes. They've had a lot of new stuff, and it's really, really awesome. They've just been overwhelmed with the business, and they apologize if they've not been able to fill your order. Come on by and give them another shot. Wicked Marinero in Red Bay, Alabama. Jet sweep to the right side. It's Max. Max with 5, maybe 8 yards, all the way up to the 47-yard line. Appreciate Belmont Pharmacy, Bill Donald Weatherford and Pam Moore. Miss Kathy Kellum, of course, now location in Red Bay. It's Red Bay Pharmacy. Your Edward Jones agent is, of course, Mike Jones at 128 North Jackson Avenue, 332-7924. So the Tigers have third down and two. Rooker and Max Bullen to the left side with a minute 42 clock running. We're down 21-6. There's the pass to Rooker. Rooker's going to make the catch. And Rooker's got a first down all the way down to the 41-yard line of Sheffield. Appreciate Daniel Garrison out there tonight. Man, we got folks everywhere checking us out, and we really appreciate that.
That was a fine pass from the quarterback over to Mr. Rooker.
Got Eddie and Lucinda Barnes out there tonight. Alex Lynch, hand off to the right side. And
now this is something I don't understand. A minute and 22 to go in the half, and we're running the ball.
You're going to have to get a timeout. If they got it to the 40-yard line, it'll be second down and about 8. So Red Bay will get a timeout. Regina Boyd out there tonight. Norma Fennell out there checking this out tonight. Tracy Gordon. Remember, put us a little message on there and let us know. Hey, there's Keith Ledbetter out there checking in. Tony and Lynette Horton out there tonight. Cheryl Winchester checking us out as well. We appreciate Swamp John's Restaurant and Catering. Get hooked on Swamp John's, located at the intersection 24247. Hey, I got you good news. Brand new hours at Swamp John's. You know, they were only doing 5 to 1 Monday through Saturday. Now they're open Monday through Wednesday 5 to 1, Thursday 5 to 7, Friday 5 to 8, and Saturdays 5 to 8. The brand new hours at Swamp John's. Make sure you tell them you heard about it right here on WRMG. We also want to thank Franklin County Probate Judge Barry Moore, Allen and Ash Harden and Harden Heating and Cooling. Also, Dr. Rick Wooten at Wooten Chiropractic, Injuries, Drug and Alcohol Testing, DOT Testing, 301 Jackson Avenue, 331-0208. Also, Chris and Valerie Mara, your authorized Freightliner and RV dealer. That's Bay Diesel and Air Conditioning. Also, Redmont Heating and Cooling with Patrick Brooks. Of course, A-State license and gives you free estimates on new installs and that type of stuff. Certified, license bonded. 662-279-6569. The Tigers, with the timeout here, will have second down and 8 when play resumes, and we're about to do that. We're going to send Kobe King to the right along with Rooker. Max is in the slot over to the left side. Quarterback back to pass. Looking downfield, he's got, incomplete. And a ball got tipped up, and I believe Sheffield may have intercepted that ball. Man, what an interception. It was intended for Kobe King. Kobe got a hand on it, and that ball got tipped up. And guess what? Sheffield gets the interception. And there's where it got tipped up, and Sheffield will get it. So that, but are they talking it over, saying it's incomplete? Maybe we got a break there.
Yeah, they're saying incomplete.
Now they're saying incomplete after the officials got together and ruled it, so we've still got a chance.
Jack, that's on the other side from us, and I couldn't tell. But I'm glad they decided to make that an incomplete pass. Be second and 10 with a minute and 17 to go here. We're on the 40-yard line.
We are on the 40, second down and 10. We're down to, like Keith said, a minute 17 to go. Red Bay trails, by the way, 21-6. 21-6. Don't forget the Red Bay Tiger Marching Band and Sheffield Band at halftime. Right here on the Ivy Broadcasting Company. Want to say how much we appreciate MedExpress of Red Bay, Kayla Humphreys and her staff. Also, Tristan Insurance, Kim and Caleb Wells, Mike Moore, Brenda Persons, and locations in Red Bay and Belmont. Also, Kim Lindsay does all you screen printing and monogram. We're still trying to get the ball spotted. It's going to be now second down and 8. They didn't have it back in the right spot. Now, that is where it's supposed to be because we had got, remember, 2 yards from Aaron Louie.
Yeah, it's third down.
So they are going to move it to third down now.
We're ready.
Appreciate Sparks Contracting. Jamie Sparks, thank you. Over 20 years experience. 662-523-8588. He does anything from new homes, remodeling, gutters, that seamless gutters, siding, metal roofing concrete work. He does it all. Also, Movie Mania, a big sponsor, along with B.J. Elrod Walters at B.J.'s Hair Accessories. We're going to fake the sweep. We're going to go to an out pattern over here, and he's going to be out of bounds with a completed catch inside the 30. Luke Rooker, Kate.
Yeah, the 29.
Hopefully we're still sounding good wherever you're at tonight. Do me a favor. Let us know if you're listening to the game tonight. We surely would appreciate it.
Yeah, we're on the 29. That was a good play. We got it. Good pass from the quarterback. Good catch there by Mr. Rooker and got out of bounds and didn't have to use timeout.
A minute 11 to go. A minute 11 to go.
On the 29.
Tigers, two receivers to the right, and one of them is going to come left, and we're going to fake the old sweep, and now we're going to have the route. We got a man out there, and it is overthrown.
Oh,
now, that would have been a touchdown.
He was open.
Live coverage of Red Bay Tiger football tonight, not only on the radio, on television, we're on internet, we're on Facebook Live tonight.
That was a wheel route Mr. Rooker ran, and he was wide open.
Miss Sue Hellum said we was loud and clear. Miss Sue, you've got enough internet out there, we're live video on Facebook. I'm not sure how much video they got out there, internet. We're going to run that ball to Aaron Louie to the right side. Louie turns that ball in down to the 25-yard line. So we're down to 55 seconds. We'll have to use another first down right here.
We got another timeout.
So the Tigers get another timeout.
It's going to be a second down, third down 5.
Hey, Danny Latham. Here we go. I've got a score here. Belmont. Let's see here. Belmont 13-6. Let's see if I can get an update. I hadn't been keeping up with this, and I should have. But New Albany's leading 28-0. Belmont's leading 13-12.
Who's Belmont playing?
Belmont is playing Alcorn Central on the road tonight. Ooh. And New Albany.
That'd be a big win for those young men.
It would.
Yeah, all right. Go Cardinals.
And so we've got another timeout. So New Albany leading right now, once again, 28-0. And Belmont leading 13-12. So the Tigers up to the line of scrimmage, third down and 5. We're down to 55 seconds to go. The quarterback back to pass, looking, and he's got the catch inside the 5-yard line
to two.
Luke Rooker.
On the 3-yard line.
What a catch by the Red Bay Tigers. Rooker on a beautiful toss there from Kobe Bragwell. So the Tigers trying to get in the end zone, trailing 21-6. We got 45 seconds to go. We line up in the old bone. We're going to run it. And
touchdown,
there's Aaron Louie.
Touchdown.
touchdown, Red Bay Tigers. So the Tigers get it into the end zone for the touchdown. And
we need to make these 2 points, Jack.
No doubt about it. Let's see here. What audio is brilliant? Need a Tiger comeback. This world is watching. That's Danny Latham up in Chicago. All right, we're going for two. It's 21-12. We need this one, as Keith said, big time. We're going to roll it out. And they threw it a little bit too quick for Kennedy. Kennedy didn't have time to get turned around, but they was all over our quarterback, Kobe Bragwell, on that rollout on the two-point conversion. So the two-point conversion is no good. It's 21-12.
It's 37 seconds to go here.
Today's game brought to you by McKinney RV. Also, don't forget, Theron, we appreciate you and the family making the game possible tonight. The Banner Tire Store on the Fairview Banner Road. Tiny Tigers Pre-K, that's Angeline Chamblee, the owner there. Ages 18 months to 4 years. Don't forget, she's got a state pre-K class, a before and after school as well. Also got a summer program open 5:30 to 5:30, 356-8736. Dr. Jim Neighbors, nurse practitioner Carolyn Wilson at the Neighbors Clinic, the city of Red Bay, along with Big Star, Hal Keaton and the staff, by Franklin Electric, H&R Block of Red Bay, Iuka Fulton, by Redmont Pharmacy, J.C. Weeks and the staff on the Golden Road, by CBNS Bank with Mary Ellen Allen and the crew, 356-9547, by Grace Long Real Estate on our broadcast here tonight. And, of course, I want to thank Davis Ford down in Fulton, Red Bay Rentals, Mr. Johnny Weatherford. Don't forget, he's got climate control as well. He's also leasing right now the 12 by 24, 10 by 20, and 10 by 10 mini storage as well. Also, consider the Lilies. They got the best pricing around on diffusers and oils. And all. You also got the floral and gift. They got the biggest selection of anybody there and great, great prices. Once again, there's the kickoff. Consider the Lilies. Back to the 30-yard line. Missed a tackle, 35. Breaks another tackle. He's up to the 40. Finally, we're going to get him down at the 40. And that's where Sheffield will put it in play, first at 10 with 27 seconds to go.
Yeah, we got him corralled there right there at the, on the 37-yard line.
Mr. Pound's in on the stop. Bunny Gray at Davis Realty, along with that great-tasting Carl Lewis sausage. A big shout-out to Dr. Stephen Ray's Family Dentistry, 356-889. Had some of Doc's barbecue before the game tonight. He's been practicing since 1993. Dr. Ray, Michelle, Regina, Amy, and Candice, thank you all for the wonderful job you do at Dr. Stephen Ray's Family Dentistry. They're going to hand that ball to the left side. He's going to try to get it outside. He cuts it in over the 45 up to about the 49-yard line. He picked up about 8 or 9 yards on that one.
Yeah, they call in timeout with 17 seconds.
So a timeout, Sheffield. That'll give us a chance to tell you about Gary Armstrong. It does all your Dozier backhoe work. Let me give you that number for Mr. Gary Armstrong, 256-810-4596. You know, we're down to 17 seconds to go. Second quarter, 21-12 is your score. 21-12 is your score. We're broadcasting the game live tonight on radio.
Jack,
yes, sir.
I had a mother stop me coming in, and her daughter is a cheerleader, and this is the first game she's been able to get to see her. And the cheerleader's name is Kayla Shea Scott. So she wants me to give her a shout-out from her mom. So
maybe we can
there
get
you
old,
go.
Maybe we can get old Byron to get us a quick scan of those cheerleaders down there. And I know they're looking toward the field right now. I don't know where Byron – he may not – he can get a quick one here. So maybe Miss Scott can spot her in that crowd. And when they introduce them later, we'll try to get that as well. So, and during timeouts, we'll do that as well. So appreciate you being out there tonight. Thank you, Miss Scott. Well, Sheffield not satisfied with the lead here. They got the ball at their own 49. They're going to pump it up. Long throw down the field. They got a receiver out there. We've got it covered well, and it's overthrown down at the 5-yard line.
Yeah, Mr.
Down to 9 seconds to go.
Mr. King and Mr. Vincent had him double covered. That was good position, guys. 9 seconds left.
Oh, Max Howell. Max is down there out in the war country down there. Max ain't got too good of internet down there for video, but Max is watching us down there.
All right.
Whenever he's got enough cell or enough internet service down there, Max, that video takes up a lot, don't it? down to the 41-yard line. That's probably going to be the last play.
You want me to leave this microphone?
Yeah,
here,
please. Yes, sir. I don't know where you got a good place to leave it so it won't get too wet down there. So we got a 21-12 game. We're at halftime. Don't forget we got the bands coming up. Thanks to 4th Street Grill and Steakhouse, Lori and Brent Collum. And Lori's daughter down there, Miss Bill Stein, will be twirling that old baton down there. Ronnie Cook, your Modern Woodman agent, 662-423-8477. Also want to thank Red Bay Hospital, taking care of your friends and family close to home. Triple D's Bucket Service, Page Clearing, at Joel Caroline and Jody Page, Red Bay Gas and Water, along with Sunshine Meals.
Good
Mike
evening,
Schubert, your hometown school board member.
This-
also want to thank Cash and Thermoplastics by your hometown Piggly Wiggly. Sunshine Mills, thank you so much. Don't forget to call before you dig at Red Bay Gas and Water, 356-8622. Also, Mike Engel at Engel Farms, thank you so much. Don't forget to stay right where you're at if you want to enjoy the band, and we're going to take it back down to field level and let you enjoy the good audio of the band. Don't forget Red Bay Band coming up right after the band from Sheffield.
And now on with the show.
Thank you.
The band is under direction of band director Jennifer Jay and auxiliary sponsor Morgan Murray. Auxiliary captains are Hope Andrews, Tisha Andrews, Carson Bryan, and Savannah Tucker. Thank you and go Dogs!
A very fine performance. You did your school proud, Sheffield Band. You really did. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Please join me with your applause in welcoming the Red Bay Tiger Marching Band onto the field. Captain for the Tiger Band is Anna Jackson. Color Guard Captain is Maya Jackson. Our majorettes are Madison Farrow and Layla Bilstein. Tonight, the Marching Tiger Band presents Queen. We Will Rock You is the first music selection. Then follows Bohemian Rhapsody, featuring trumpet soloist Anna Jackson. And we end with Crazy Little Thing Called Love. The band is under direction of Mr. Jonathan Hill. The band is under the field direction of Drum Major Ethan Ray. Drum Major Ethan Ray, is your band ready? Let the performance begin. Applause for that fine performance, the Red Bay Marching Band.
You know what they feed?
At this time, the band would like to say thank you to the following community members and businesses: Community Spirit Bank, Sunshine Mills, Trinity Assembly of God, Dr. Ray Dentistry, Lindsay and Winchester, 4th Street Grill, Subway, Mr. and Mrs. Hugh Johnson, Citizens Bank, Jack's, Miranda Smith, Cardinal Drive-In, Swamp John's, Piggly Wiggly, True Value, and Redmont Pharmacy. And don't forget, the band is still selling chances on the cooler until the last home game. Chances can be purchased at the concession stand. Now on with the game.
A little halftime break there. And, of course, this is WRMG TV 12 and also Television 97. Hope you enjoyed the band's halftime performance for the Sheffield Bulldogs and the Red Bay Tigers. Red Bay's going to be kicking off. We got 21-12 the score. Sheffield is on top, so must-win game for the Tigers tonight. Need to win this one big time. Keith Kennedy, Keith, are you back yet? I see him heading this way. Tigers going to be kicking off. So the Tigers will be kicking off. Murray, a little squib kick going down to about the 26-yard line, back to the 30, up to the 33-yard line before several Tigers are there and on the stop. Mr. Scott, Mr. Pounds, and I believe number 11, Mr. Kobe King, also in on the stop for the Red Bay Tigers. Live coverage of Red Bay Tiger football here on the Ivy Broadcasting Company. Do me a favor. We're streaming the game live on Facebook tonight. A lot of folks may have checked away there for a little bit at halftime. Hopefully you'll rejoin us back up here in the third quarter. Once again, Red Bay trailing 21-12. 21-12 is the score. And Sheffield got the ball at their own 34-yard line. They'll have first down and 10. They're going to run it to the left side, number 21. He's up over the 35 to the 37-yard line. Keith, we're going to have to turn it up a notch on the defensive side, aren't we? Hang on. Might help if I turn your mic up. I'm sorry.
Got me?
I got you. Go ahead.
All right. Yeah, we just they're getting around on that end. They're getting out to the second tier of players pretty quick on the end, and they're fixing to get us far. For substitution room.
So we got Sheffield here, second down. And it looks like they're going to Tigers going to have an illegal substitution, so they're going to staff some yardage off against the Tigers. Live coverage of Red Bay Tiger football tonight brought to you by Mike Engel at Engel Farms. Don't forget, if you need chicken, litter, haul, or spread, call Mike Engel at Engel Farms, 256-668-0775. Second down and only a yard to go. Lanier Cheatham, the quarterback, looks over to the side to get a play. He's had a lot of success with Carroll, that running back, tonight. They've run him big time, and he's had a very successful night. He's going to get the ball again. He's got a first down over the 45 up to the 46-yard line. Great job by the bands tonight. Congratulations on a great, great job.
Yeah, that tackle there, Jack, was by Mr. Tanner Nichols and Elijah Ingles, our number 66 there. And we hadn't called old 72's name out much tonight, so all right, Ethan, you get after him out there, buddy.
Yeah, we need Ethan. Tigers make the stop on first down for Sheffield. Sheffield gets it over the midfield marker. They're going to mark it right at midfield. It'll be, what, second down about seven, something like that?
Yeah, something like that. That's Mr. Kobe Braggle was in on that play over there. So second down six here.
We got Red Bay and Sheffield football live tonight. Got old Andy Deaton out there tonight. Austin Ballou, Charlotte Sims shots out there. Miss Betty McKinney and also Sharon Blackburn checking out a broadcast. Quarterback back to pass. Across the middle, almost intercepted. Yeah. Cam McKinney covering 25, and Kobe Bragwell on the tip, almost got it.
Yeah, I don't. Was he throwing that to number 25? I don't know who he was throwing.
I think so.
Yeah, it's gonna be second down, or third down seven here.
Alcorn Central leading Belmont at halftime, 20-19.
Oh, there's another pack. We got a penalty here.
New Albany leading Tisch County 48-0 at a half. That over there, and that's going to be another flag against the Red Bay Tigers.
Holding, defensive holding.
So first down and 10 for the Sheffield Bulldogs, just inside the Red Bay Tiger 40-yard line. Two receivers left. One to the right. Quarterback's going a little quarterback draw this time. Pulls it down. He cuts it back to the middle, down to about the 36-yard line. Pickup of about four. We'll call it second down and six.
Yeah, we, Mr. Cam McKinney and Tanner Nichols in on that tackle. We need a turnover. They hadn't had a turnover tonight. We need a turnover.
They got two receivers left, one right this time, that quarterback. We'll bring another back there right beside him, and they're going to run that ball to the right side. He's going to turn around and just kind of go backwards into the line and picks up some yardage down to about the 31-yard line. He's not going to be too far short of the first down. It'll be third down.
Third and two.
And a couple of yards to go for the first down. Streaming the game live tonight on WRMG TV 12 and also Television 97. Remember to let us know if you're out there watching the broadcast tonight. We surely would love to hear from you. There's 21 Carroll running it. He's got a first down. He gets to the outside over the 30. Down inside the 30 to about the, looks like maybe the 27-yard line.
Yeah, that's Mr. Tanner Nichols over on that tackle. Jack there just using up his third quarter here on us. They just methodically driving it down the field here on us. We need a big play here, guys.
8:57 to go, third quarter, 21-12, Sheffield. And Sheffield took this third quarter kickoff, and they get it down close to the 26-yard line. They're going to have second down into, what, seven?
Seven, yeah.
Keith, we missed you last week. Max and I had a good time down in Bern.
I bet. We went down, visited with Kurt a little bit, and enjoyed that ball game until about 6 seconds to go and sort of let it slip away.
So second down and about seven to go for Sheffield. Sheffield in the shotgun. That's where they've been all night. Little swing pass out to the left. Tigers come up. Let's see if Max can make a play. He does not. The guy breaks a tackle to the 25, down to the 20. Fumble.
We got it. We got it. And we got that ball.
And the Red Bay Tigers have come Max up Willen with a fumble it. Recovery.
All right.
You know, Max missed the tackle up there, but he came back, but, didn't give up.
That's hustle. Yes, sir.
He came right back and tried to help out and did.
All right.
And got the fumble recovery.
That's what we're needing there, right, Jack. We've been talking about it.
So the Red Bay Tigers. Oh, John Mattson still at work. He's checking in on the game up in Scarborough, Maine tonight. Sounding good. Tracy says we're sounding good down in Tampa, Florida tonight. First down and 10 to go for the Red Bay Tigers. We've got it at our own 20, trailing 21 to 12. We're going to have to get on the stick and get this ball moving. We're going to go to the right side, and Aaron Louie gets his best run of the night. Gets it up to the 31-yard line. He's got a first down, 11 yards. And big guys on the line, Keith, they're going to have to buckle down and get some good blocks up front.
Yeah,
and
right.
Those big guys we're talking about, it's Hunter Tyler. I've got Mr. Engel up there. Also, we got number 70, Dylan Hester, up there. Dylan, of course, snapping that football. Who else we got on that right
Mr.
side?
Mr. Levi Raper, 61.
And Louie trying to get to the outside. This time they string him out, and he's not going to get it back to the line of scrimmage. It'll be second down and about 11. We have not had as much success last week or this week getting to the outside.
Jack, I still say a reverse. We could pick up some yards.
Miss Anna Turberfield Wooten watching down in Naples, Florida tonight, says go Tigers. So second down and 11. We're going to bring Rooker to the left side. Also bringing over here is Kobe King to the left. We're going to go to Kobe. He needs a block, and he gets one, 35. And he's going to get to the 36 before they push him back. Good job of Max up blocking, just to free that play up a little bit, enough to get about five on the play. Third down and five. Tigers need to keep this drive going right here. Trails 21 to 12. We're in the third quarter, 6 minutes and 41 seconds to go.
That was a pass play there on second down. That's good.
Wayne Waddle. Wayne, we just told you that score, 21 to 12. Red Bay with the ball right now. Red Bay trailing. Max Bullen trying to get to the outside. He's got a first down and more over the 45. We'll see where they said he stepped out. He may have stepped out at the 42-yard line, but he's going to still have enough for the first down. So Wayne Waddle, thank you. And also we got a user down in Pearl, Mississippi. Oh, Joey Allen out there checking in the game right now. Once again, we're WRMG, TV 12, TV 97 tonight at Facebook Live as well. Appreciate Alpha Insurance, Mr. John Cook on our broadcast here tonight. First down and 10 for the Red Bay Tigers. Tigers bring two receivers to the left side. Kobe Bragwell, your quarterback's going to go to Louie. Louie, 45, 50, breaks it down to the 45, down to the 41-yard line. Aaron Louie on a nice run of about 15.
That's Keith. 18 yards.
18. I was cutting him short about three.
That's from the 41 to the 41.
We got, of course, Community Spirit Bank on our broadcast tonight. The Cardinal drive-in out on the Golden Road. They'll be open late after the game. Alpha Insurance, we told you about Dr. Fabianchi. What about Stadium Pros? What about Bay Tree Gift Company? And Lindsay, Jane, Lori, and the staff, the best gift selection you'll find anywhere. And they're out on the Golden Road right next to WRMG. Here's a handoff to the left side. Max has got it. We got a long flag flying across the field. They threw the flag at about the 45. That play, line of scrimmage, was about 41.
We picked up about 3 yards on the play.
That guy that threw that flag threw it about we got another chop block against the Red Bay Tigers. That's two of those calls against the Tigers tonight. Don't forget, if you'd do us another favor, if you've not shared this link with your friends out there to let them know how they can get the game tonight, we'd love for you to do that at this time. And we really appreciate you joining us here tonight. Once again, we're streaming it on Facebook Live tonight. Keith, the old Astros leading the Yankees after 4-2 tonight. Belmont and Alcorn Central in a battle down at Farmington tonight over close to Corinth. Belmont needs that game. That's one of the games they had kind of penciled in that you think the Cardinals could win, but Alcorn Central, a much better team than they normally are. Nothing, taking nothing against Alcorn Central, but they are playing much, much better this year. Appreciate Dr. Ralph Nix, Family Dentistry, located behind the post office. You can reach them at 356-8641. Tiffin Motorhomes. We got first down and about 25 to go. Here comes Max to the left side. 45 up to the 50. Down to the 48. Falls forward to the 47-yard line. Keith, he got a late flag on this. And the head guy threw that flag late.
Yeah.
I'd take a personal foul against Sheffield, wouldn't you?
Yeah, I would.
He got about...
He got about 8-9 yards.
We'll see what this flag is all about. Mr. Byron Hillams has got the camera. Personal foul against Sheffield. I get my wishes. They'll step that off from the end of the run. That's going to move it all the way down inside the 35 to the 33.
Yeah, we're
going to
be about a going to be second and one. Second down, 1 yard.
So great play by the Tigers on the run and then getting the penalty on top of that. We trail 21-12. We're in the third quarter tonight with 5 minutes and 20 seconds to go. I'm Jack Ivey, Keith Kennedy. We got Byron Hillams and Denise back at Control Center and hoping to try to get a Tiger win before this one's over. Time's running out in a hurry.
5:20 to go here in the third quarter.
Tigers sending number 17, Mr. Humphreys, to the right side. Tigers go to the out, and boy, that's been a good play for us tonight.
That's a pretty play.
Oh, Mr. Luke Rooker.
Yeah, down the. We're on the 23-yard line.
So Red Bay Tiger football tonight, production of the Ivy Broadcasting Company. We appreciate you very, very much.
Jack, that's a pretty play, and you've got a both guys. So you got a your quarterback's got to make that's a. Got to have a strong arm to make that throw, and then Rooker running a good pattern and catching the ball.
Hand it off to Louie. Louie, a little runner room down to the 20-yard line before they push him back. So he's going to pick up about four. I want to say hello to Ronnie and Miss Sue Hellams after tonight. And I know the other Brent and his family is on the road heading over to Atlanta tonight to check on Miss Carly's dad. And he keeps improving, so y'all
isn't
continue to pray for him.
Yeah, isn't that great?
Awesome.
All right.
I know those boys was kind of excited about getting to see their papa.
Yeah, sir. It's going to be second down 7, Jack.
Appreciate Tiffin Motorhomes along with Miss Ann Vincent at Fastway Car Wash. Here's the handoff again to Louie. Louie runs into brick wall, but he's down to the 15-yard line. That Tiger offense pushes him forward inside the 10 down to the 9. They should have had him at the 16. Yeah. But those linemen kept pushing, and Louie's feet kept churning. And he is inside the 10-yard line. First down and goal, Red Bay Tigers. And that kind of gets us a little bit more excited than we've been all night long.
This is what I'm talking about, Jack, a little passion. These guys, they play them with a little passion now. It just makes things better, I can tell you.
Tigers two receivers to the left side. Louie sitting right beside the quarterback. He's going to get it. No, the quarterback's going to pull it down right up the middle, down
he's
to the
down
five.
To, he's to down the two.
Two-yard line. That's Colby Bragwell. Got a lot of folks watching us tonight online at WRMG Live and also Jack Ivey Live. So if you're out there, do me a favor. I'm going to do it right now. I want you to do it too. Share the link so everybody can find out the game is live on Facebook Live tonight. Tigers have second down and goal at the 2-yard line. Give it to Louie to the right side. Touchdown, Red Bay Tigers. So the Tigers have not been successful on the two-point conversions tonight. They've got 18 on the board. It's now 21-18. Right now would be a good time. Keith, turn that old microphone around there. Let's listen to that Red Bay Tiger band. Tigers going for two. They're going to go to Louis. Louis trying to get to the outside.
He's got it.
He's in there. Two-point conversion. Red Bay Tigers. We're only down 21-20, and we'll be kicking off here on the Red Bay Tiger Football Network. There's a Red Bay Tigers.
Hey, Jack, doesn't it sound so much better?
All the fans are into it. The cheerleaders are into it. We're into it.
Yeah, that's what I'm talking about.
Well, there's some of those Red Bay Tiger cheerleaders down there. We'll let you listen to the band a little bit more. Cheerleaders doing an outstanding job. Maybe you see your daughter or granddaughter on the sideline. Make sure you tell them you saw them cheering on TV 12 and TV 97. Don't forget, we'll have this on our YouTube channel by the time you get up in the morning. Keith, I saw Mr. Craig and some of his cousins and whatever.
Yeah.
Your sister's in town watching
game
tonight.
Yeah, my sister's in town. Check on mother. And Brent, her son's in med school at UAB. This is his first semester, so he's got a lot of work ahead of him.
No doubt, but I know she's very proud of him. Hey, Danny Latham said, boom! Shannon Eubanks out there checking us out tonight. Robert Royal watching up in Memphis, says go Tigers. 23-yard line on the kickoff, back to the 30. Tigers corral him, stop him at about the 33-yard line. So Sheffield will have it first down and 10. We just need a big defensive stop. Right now we don't need no flag, and that's exactly what was thrown. So hopefully this flag's not against us. Coach,
there's three of them down there.
Hey, y'all take the ball. Come on.
So they're going to talk this over. Not a good situation. Now, the play kept continuing. The wheels were blowing, and we pushed him back and finally got him down. And then some temper started flaring down there. And, you know, we've already got the momentum in our side right now. Even though we're down 21-20, you don't need to – you need them to take the ball at the 32-yard line, not give them 15 yards, and we'll find out exactly what this play is all about here in a minute. Keith, we do not need to give up a personal foul here. I'm hoping they're going to do it on both sides, and just that'd be an easy way out. Here we go. Personal foul against Sheffield. Personal foul against Red Bay. Offset. That's the easy way out, but that's okay.
Yeah, that's what should have happened.
We got Jamie Scott out there checking us out tonight. Miss Brenda Elliott, Terry Hester, Runda, Spencer Barksdale, Josh Sinkbell out there, Dexter Ezel, Tim Hopkins out there watching. Susan and Gary Puckett watching on Facebook Live. Now, you new folks that have joined us, maybe you hadn't shared this link on your Facebook page. Go share it right now. Let us know how it looks where you're watching tonight. We need some feedback from you, you know what I mean? Tell me how good it looks and how good it sounds, or if it don't, tell me the truth. There's a handoff. 32-yard line, breaking the outside. Come on, give a tackle. We miss another tackle at the 38. We finally get him out of bounds at about the 44-yard line. We should have had him back at the 38. And he's going to get, I believe, a first down. They've already moved the chains.
Yeah, it's first down.
It doesn't matter. They've already moved the chain. They moved the chains.
They moved them.
And guess what? It ain't. I'm not sure it is a first down.
No, he's short of the 45. No, they give it to him, yeah.
That may be the easy way just to give him the first down because they had already moved the chains.
The official, the head official, the one with the white cap, his name is Gary Evans, and he and I have been buddies a long, long time, and he's got some sense, and some of these others may not, but no, he has.
Keith, we got Miss Sheila Sparks out there watching tonight, and also Tim Tiffin out there watching
tonight.
Red Bay Tiger football. First down and 10, Sheffield. We got a 21-20 ball game. Little toss pass, incomplete. Good job. You was wondering where Ethan was at. Ethan was in the quarterback's face on that one, wasn't he?
Yeah. Jack, I got a story to tell you about Van and his dad up here. You know, Mr. Bob used to come up here, and they'd have 50 footballs out here kicking them. You know, they just kick and kick and kick.
Second down and 10, Sheffield at their own 44-yard line. Sheffield leads 21-20 here in the third quarter with 3:15 to go. Quarterback's going to pull this one down. He's to the right side, 45-50, down to the 48-yard line. before the Tigers there to make the stop. Mr. Meyer and
Mr. who else? Yeah, as Alex in on that play, number 80 and 66. And
Keith, we got the world-famous Judy Perrigan watching over in Florence tonight.
All right. Hey, Miss Judy.
Terry Hester down in Pearl, Mississippi. Miss Lucille Bryson out there.
Third and three.
Polk County, Florida. Stacy Enzie out there watching. Tyler Jeffries, Jason Harrison watching out on the road tonight, I guess. Judy Robinson Kilby sounding good over in Cloverdale tonight. Third down and three for Sheffield. There's the Red Bay Tiger 48-yard line. They lead. Quarterback rolls out to the left. His pass is going to be caught. First down, down to the 40, and we got a flag coming in.
Yeah.
And they got down about the 35-yard line of Red Bay, then that flag rolled in. We'll wait and see what this flag's all about. That guy's got some good eyes.
Yeah, he got a push.
He's standing about 20-yard line, that flag.
Did you see that flag? It's like it just making a circle coming down.
Oh, I thought it dropped out of an airplane or something. Yeah. But Eric Perry out there watching tonight. Don't forget, we'd love to hear from you. If you've not shared this link, it's not too late. We're trying to get more and more folks watching out there tonight, and you can help us out by doing that right now. Live coverage here on the Ivy Broadcasting Company. Block in the back against Sheffield. They step it off, and that'll move it right back to the line of scrimmage, and they're going to have third down and two. How big is this defensive play right here?
Yeah.
We're down to 2:23 to go in the third quarter. Red Bay trails 21-20. Quarterback in the shotgun. That is Cheatham. You can look for him to either run it himself or go to Carroll, the running back, number 21. Quarterback's going to pull it down himself. Tigers hit him and push him back, but he's going to get some forward progress, and I believe they're going to give him enough forward progress for the first down. So it'll be should be first down for Sheffield at the Red Bay Tigers 46-yard line. Appreciate Tiffin Motorhomes featuring Allegro making the game possible tonight. Roughing it smoothly on down the road for many, many years. Tiffin Motorhomes, of course, doing it right here in Red Bay, Alabama. Over in Belmont, over Winfield, Iuka, the surrounding areas, but they do a wonderful job down at Tiffin Motorhomes. We really appreciate them for sponsoring the game tonight. A big shout out tonight to the Deaton Funeral Home of Red Bay and Belmont, and also Alvin Mason Construction. Little option running to the right side. That's at number 21. He gets it down to the 41-yard line. Cam McKinney
and Mr. Kobe Bragwell, number four, in on
Bragwell.
They're just getting to our ends way too quick. We're not stringing them out. They get to our ends and get headed downfield too quick on us. And second down and four.
So Sheffield with second down at about five. Quarterback rolls out to pass. One-on-one coverage. Now he's going to pull it down and run it. He's got it inside the 40, down to the 35. He's going to be a little forward progress, and he's going to have another first down for the Sheffield Bulldogs. Alex Kennedy across the way and on the stop. We got a lot of folks watching. Miss Jane Edwards out there watching tonight. Remember, we would love to say hello to you. Let us know where you're at tonight. Pearl Pirates winning tonight, 49-0 over George County. That game down in central Mississippi tonight. First down and 10 for the Sheffield Bulldogs. They lead Red Bay 21-20. Sheffield going to keep it on the ground, run it. They turn it into the 30, down to the 26-yard line. Keith, they're just getting too many yards up the middle.
Yeah. We need to start talking about another turnover, don't we, Jack?
That's right. You talked about it earlier and got it. Cam McKinney and all that stuff.
Yeah, second down and one.
Old John Matson.
Yeah, they're just knocking us off the ball. That's going to be the end of the third quarter.
So the third quarter coming to a close. Sheffield leading the Red Bay Tigers in a must-win game for Red Bay tonight. We need this one. We got to go to Sullivan next week. We'll be live down there. I don't know where we'll have a good enough internet to stream it live video, but you'll be able to listen to the game as always. Calvert Heights leading over Calvert County 27-7. And we're going to take it down to the field as they bring the flag down. Fourth quarter coming up. Tigers are holding up four. I hope that's good luck. We need a big fourth quarter here by the Red Bay Tigers here tonight. Jack Ivey live with Keith Kennedy, Byron Helms, Denisa back at Control Center tonight. And once again, we're live tonight on the Ivey Broadcasting Company. Red Bay Tigers trailing 21-20. And Sheffield will have the ball.
On the 26-yard line.
So Sheffield coming out, we'll have second down and a couple of yards to go. So the fourth quarter about to get underway. Jack Ivey, Keith Kennedy here. Keith down on the sideline. Keith standing down about the 15-yard line.
Yeah, it's on the 26, second one.
And they're going to hand it off to number six this time. He's got a first down as he turns it in. Inside the 20, maybe down to the 17, 18 yard line.
Yeah, he's about
line.
Between the 17 and 18.
They're going to have first down and 10. So we got an injured player, so there'll be a stop of the action. That's one of the Red Bay Tigers down there. And he's on his knees. Hopefully he's going to be all right. That looks like Mr. Engel, Mike Engel. Son there. So hopefully Elijah's going to be okay.
Yeah, he'll be all right, maybe.
Got there listening to our broadcast tonight. Honored to have you on our broadcast here on WRMG TV 12 and also Television 97. Once again, the injured player for the Red Bay Tigers is Elijah Engel. And today's game brought to you by some great folks like Fastway Car Wash, Miss Ann Vincent, and Elijah is up.
That right ankle's, he looks like he's favoring it a little bit, so maybe get over here and shake it off.
Appreciate Dickie Spark, CPA.
He's a tough young man.
No doubt about it.
All right, does Tigers, great job. We need to.
After thousands of calls throughout the years inquiring about insurance from our neighbors who live in Mississippi, well, old Ronald Thorne's excited. He can now take care of all your insurance needs. Call Ronald 256-356-4459. And also, don't forget Wicked Marinero is open, wide open. And they got a guy that moved over there on the right side.
At number 12, he's wanting to get started, bless his heart. That's twice. He just took off.
Now, he only took about one step in earlier. How many did he take?
He took about five or so, yeah.
They'll let you by with a half, but.
That's going to move it back to the 26, so it's going to be first and 15. And now up to 26, about 23.
Red Bay Tigers tonight live at home.
Man, we had a shot at him in the backfield and didn't lock up. He got picked up four. It's going to be second down and 11. He's back to about the 19-yard line.
Second down and 11. Sheffield leads Red Bay 21-20 with 11:24 to go in the ballgame. We're live in Red Bay tonight. Quarterback in the shotgun. And this time he's going to hand it off to the left side. That's 21 again. We do a good job stopping
right.
him this time.
Yeah, we stopped him up right to the line of scrimmage. That a baby. That way you do it. That's Mr. Max Bullen on the bottom. That a way. Got that head in there and shoulders around him.
Good job, Alex. Number 80 and
number 77, Joseph Mueller. There, way to go.
Cam McKinney coming in there to help out. See, I got the advantage on you. I'm watching a little replay up here as well.
Logan Scott there, number two. It's going to be third down, and we'll call it eight, Jack.
Quarterback rolling out to the right side on third down and eight. He'll pull it down, and the Tigers make a good one-on-one tackle.
Mr. Tanner Nichols, way to go, buddy. He tackled him on about the 11-yard line. So it's
fourth and four.
Fourth and four. Yeah, they got to get down to the 7-yard line. Good play, Tanner. That's an open field tackle, and that guy's pretty elusive. So I'd want to keep your feet in balance and make a tackle.
Appreciate Predator Pest Control, Clay and Ted Weatherford, Nady Deaton. Nady's the local number, 662-315-2841 for all your termite and pest control problems. Make sure you deal with the hometown folks at Predator Pest Control. Big play here, fourth down and four. And now we're going to get a timeout, Sheffield, to talk this one over.
10 minutes to go in the game.
And the Tigers right now trailing 21-20. Boy, we need to make this stop. So the Tigers coming to the sideline to talk it over with the coaching staff. And tonight's game brought to you by Red Bay Pharmacy, now open in Red Bay. Bill, Donald Weatherford and the crew there. And they've put together an outstanding staff in Red Bay. And, of course, we'll be talking to some of those folks and introduce them to you a little bit. We're actually doing that on the radio ads right now, but we're going to get down and put their pictures on television so you can get a chance to see them up close and personal. And I know they're excited about getting it open in Red Bay, Alabama. Once again, if you have not let your friends and neighbors know, right now would be a good time to share this link and let us know if you're watching out there tonight and where you're watching. Red Bay right now trails 21-20. 21-20 is your score. We'll be live next week down in Sullivan, Alabama. But, boy, tonight is the main game that we need to win here tonight.
Yeah, we got to take care of business right here.
So,
all right, guys. Stay home and lock them arms up and make a tackle. What do you think they're going to do, Jack?
I'm going to say the quarterback's going to fake it to 21 and maybe run it. He's pretty dangerous. So. Now he's going to hand it to 21. 21's not only got the first down, he's going to be down awful close to the goal line.
Touchdown, yeah.
Down to the 1 yard line.
Inside the one.
They got an injured player down back at about the 9 yard line. So they handed it off to 21. Coach getting out to check on him in a hurry.
I think that left leg looks like got a problem with it.
So hopefully that young man's going to be okay.
They're not.
Live coverage of Red Bay Tiger football tonight. We've had a lot of folks watching us all over the country tonight. 9:52 to go in this one. We got to stop in the action here.
Yeah, that left leg is.
He is up, going to try to hobble off.
It's a good effort to get up and off. Yeah.
No doubt about it.
Well, the only thing we need here is a fumble.
Is that the only thing going to save us?
Well, it would help.
It's getting late.
Yeah.
We trailed 21-20. How much time?
9:52.
All right, here we go. Sheffield coming up with first and goal at about the 1 yard line. Sheffield, the quarterback in the shotgun, going to hand it off this time to number six, and we're going to
we hit him in the backfield there.
Hold him there, a little bit short of the original line of scrimmage.
That's Mr. Joseph Mule and Mr. Cam McKinney make that tackle. Way to go.
A lot to ask from to stop him four times, but that'd be an awesome thing to
here
do.
Here comes 21. This is the boy dog right here, 21.
Carroll checking back into the ball game after that good run. So Sheffield trying to get it in the end zone. The Tigers push him back again.
Yeah, we got him behind the line of scrimmage.
So he's going to lose. They'll probably move him back to the 2 yard line. So it'll be
third down
and go.
Way to go. We got good penetration there. Way to go, guys.
All
I can't believe they hadn't went wide. I just
third down and goal to go from the 2 yard line.
As much success as they've had wide, it just surprised me they hadn't went wide.
The wide side of the field is to the right side. They got a receiver on the left side and right side. Sheffield talking it over right now, looking at the sideline, checking it off at the line. Their quarterback is going to hand off to 21. He wiggles touchdown. His way into the end zone for a touchdown. Keith, they went right back.
21. He's
inside again.
Yeah, he's the boy dog. I don't know why they've had success outside. That sort of surprised me, them running inside, but they got it in there.
So Sheffield on the board. They've been perfect from the extra points. They lead 27-20. But the Tigers, even though they're giving them right here, you still can tie the game with a touchdown and a two-point conversion. You don't want to get yourselves in that situation, but that's probably the position we're going to be in here.
Yeah,
but
we're right there.
That's better than being down 9, right?
That's it.
We'll see if they can kick an extra point right here. Number 14
good.
Kicks it up. He's been perfect for the night. It's up and good. And that score comes with 8:13 to go in the ball game. 28-20 is the score. 28-20. Jack Ivey, Keith Kennedy here, Byron Hillis. Today's game brought to you by Edward Jones agent, Mr. Mike Jones. You know, market declines, deficit, debt crisis. Don't let those headlines derail your long-term financial strategy. Put your trust in your Edward Jones agent, Mr. Mike Jones. He does a wonderful, wonderful job. He's got an office, of course, at 128 North Jackson Avenue in Russellville. And you can call him at 256-332-7924. He's one of the hometown guys, Mr. Mike Jones. Mike, thank you so much. Swamp John's Restaurant and Catering on our broadcast here tonight. I also want to thank Alan Nash Harden at Harden Heating and Cooling, your authorized York Heating and Cooling dealer for three generations. Over 45 years in the business, 356-8913. Also, Tiffin Supply, Tiffin Appliance Company. See David, Tony, Eli, Richard, and the staff, 356-4946. Also on a broadcast here tonight is Bay Diesel and Air Conditioning, Chris and Valerie Marr, your authorized Freightliner and RV dealer. There's the kick going down to about the 15-yard line, 20, 25, up to about the 30 before they knock us down. Maybe the 31-yard line. That's where the Red Bay Tigers will put it in play, first and 10. So the Tigers down 8. We'll try to put a drive together right here. And like I say, right now we're trailing 28-20.
The ball is right on 30-yard line.
So they marked it at the 30. So the Tiger offense will head back to the field. And we're going to see what the Tigers can do down the stretch right here. Once again, we appreciate you joining us here tonight on WRMG TV 12, TV 97. So, Tigers not being able to get any yardage, Keith, on that play.
Yeah, we picked up a yard. He fumbled it, and it helped us a yard, so got out of bounds.
28-20 the score. Tigers coming up to the line of scrimmage. Shotgun formation. The quarterback back to pass. This time he's going to go downfield looking for Rooker, and Rooker cannot make the catch. Down at the 38-yard line, they had that one covered very well. Number 3 back covering for the Sheffield Bulldogs. That's Christopher Smith. They kind of faked that play that we'd been successful on and took it on downfield a little bit more after the fake. But they had a nice help coming over from the left side.
We just had one. We just had one receiver out on this side, and that's one reason. They were in double coverage, Jonas.
Appreciate Redmont Heating and Cooling. Patrick Brooks along with Dr. Rick Wooten at Wooten Chiropractic over in Russellville, Alabama. Also, big shout out to Franklin County Probate Judge Barry Moore by Med Express. Kayla Humphreys in Red Bay, 356-8907. This time we're going to Max to the left side. Max turns it in. He's got a first down over the 40. And, boy, we needed that first down. They're going to mark it right at the 40. And that will be a first down. So Red Bay will have a first down. Tri-State Insurance, Kim and Caleb Wells, Mike Moore, Brenda Purser. Also want to thank Kim Lindsay, who does all your screen printing and monogramming by Sparks Contracting. That's Jamie Sparks, over 20 years experience. He does it all. New homes, remodels, seamless gutters, siding, metal roofing, concrete work. Sparks Contracting, 662-523-8588. Movie Mania, Crystal Pearson, Destin M, and McAllister, 99 cents on new releases. We run the football. And we got a couple of yards for Aaron Louie. Daniel Humphrey's out there. And old Jesse Venable. You remember old Jesse Venable?
Yes, sir.
We called his name out a few times
we
over
did.
The year.
We did. We did. Picked up three. We're going to be second down and seven. 7:20 to go in the game.
Live coverage of Red Bay Tiger football tonight. 28-20. We're down to 7 minutes, 11 seconds. The clock running. We've got second down. About eight to go. We're at our own 43-yard line. We got a receiver to the right side. The only one we're sending out. We're going to come to Max to the right side. He's going to turn it in and basically no gain. Tigers will send in Logan Scott as Kobe King will check out of the ball game. Told you about Movie Mania, that number 256-810-1327. New releases only 99 cents a night. Also, Theron McKinney and all of his family at McKinney RV, the Banner Tire Store, Mr. Jason Parker and his staff, Tiny Tigers Pre-K, Angeline Chambly, Dr. Jim Neighbors, nurse practitioner Carolyn Wilson, along with the city of Red Bay, big star of Red Bay Howell and the staff. Don't forget Franklin Electric, H&R Block, and also J.C. Weeks and the staff at Redmond Pharmacy. Third down and a long six here to go. We're going to run that football here on third. We got a first down over the 50 down to the 47. And, Keith, I wouldn't have called that running play, but we did. And of course, if you get a lot of yardage, you look good on it. If I had said, hey, I want to do a running, we got an injured player. Hopefully he's going to be okay. But we ran that play, and Aaron Louie picked up the first down all the way down to the 40. It looks like that's a 47-yard line. We got a stop in the action here. Appreciate H&R Block of Red Bay Iuka Fulton. Don't forget Marilyn Allen and the staff. We got Carol Page Austin up in Savannah, Tennessee, logging in to see my little cousin play tonight. Patricia Roberts out there tonight. Way to go, Aaron Louie, there from Susan and Gary Puckett. And who else? Randy Lowry back. Oh, Chris Bierbauer out there checking
Chris,
us out.
Hey, buddy.
Tyler Jeffers said he misses this. Good luck to Red Bay tonight. Ken Williams pulling for the Tigers out in Midland, Texas tonight. Of course, good to see all these names pop up. You know, the people that there's no way that they could get back to watch a game. And Keith, is that Mr. Max?
Yeah, Max.
Max Bullen is an injured player they took off. I was doing some ads and checking in who called.
Mr. Colin Umphress went in his place here. So
Red Bay's got two receivers to the right. Now, folks, 5:57 right now. We got to get a touchdown and a two-point conversion. There's a pass, and it is incomplete, intended for Rooker at the 44-yard line. That was only about a three-yard play there.
Yeah, that was. It's going to be second and 10.
Brandy Wooten Miller out there. There's Brother David Conley out there. You know, checking in with us out in Atlanta, Georgia tonight.
All right.
Second down and 10 at the 47-yard line. Red Bay with the football. We go to Louie. Louie to the left side.
He's not going nowhere.
Maybe a yard or two. Maybe. Probably going to probably mark him at about the 45. So they'll give him two. It's third down and 8.
Yeah.
We're live on Facebook Live tonight. Luke Roberts out there checking in with us tonight. Miss Carolyn Stepp out there tonight. And I know, folks, these names pop off a pretty good bit, so we don't see it. Tammy McAlpin out there with us tonight. Miss Sue Helms and Johnny Stockton.
Third down 8 here, Jack. 5:14.
Miss Kathy Ramirez, Sue Tate out there. Here we go. Tigers going to run it, and the quarterback inside the 40.
He's got a first down.
And he's going to be awful close to the first down. Folks, that is your quarterback, Kobe Bragwell. Now, we've got two first downs on third and long. And if I'd been calling the plays, on it. I'll be honest with you, I wouldn't call that running play on either one of them just because of the longevity of it. But Coach has got a lot of confidence in that offensive line, and also his guys running. Old Billy Crutchfield out there tonight. Chris Lynch checking us out tonight. Geraldine Holt. Garrett Kelly, former Tiger out there. Terry Hester, thank you. Gail Rooker. Thank all you folks out there. Kim Lindsay checking us out, one of our big sponsors here. And the Tigers going to run it again right up the middle. Louis. Louis breaks it to the outside to the 20. He's going for the touchdown. Aaron Louis takes it for the touchdown. Folks, you can put that down as a 36-yard touchdown run by Aaron Louis and the Red Bay Tigers. Now, Keith, the big thing is we got to have a two-point conversion. That touchdown comes with 4:33 to go. Red Bay 28, or Red Bay 26, Sheffield 28. So Sheffield leads by two. Come on, Red Bay Tigers, 28-26. Sheffield leads by two, 4:33 to go. Danny Latham getting excited up in Chicago. We're going to run that ball to the right side. We're in there. The two-point conversion is good by Kobe Bragwell. Or was that Louie?
That's Louie.
Louie run it in. I'm sorry. Good job, Aaron Louie. Aaron Louie in there for the two-point conversion. And guess what? We've got a tie ball game. That's the first time we've been tied
since
the kickoff.
We started, yeah.
Since the kickoff, right?
It's that first kickoff.
Oh, man. Well, how about that? Miss Mandy Bridges Persher out there checking in with us tonight. We're all tied up 28-28. Y'all do me a favor, stay with us and call a neighbor to tell them to go to WRMG Live or Jack W. Ivy. Go on Facebook and watch the game live. I got to ask you a question. Do you like – I promise you now, we'd rather you be here and watch it in person. And I think if you wanted to be here, you'd be here tonight. But a lot of these folks, there's no way they could get to the game tonight. And they're watching online. So if you'd like to see us do some additional games down the road, if it's where we can, would you like us to do this again? And we need to kind of have a little feedback from you. So if you've enjoyed watching tonight, remember if you've got maybe a smart TV and you got the Facebook app, you can watch it on your big screen TV. I know when you stretch it out too far quality-wise, I don't know how good it is on a big screen, but you can watch it on your iPad, your computer, and whatever, and hopefully you're enjoying it, and hopefully it looks good where you're at. So if you'd like us to do this again down the road, let us know. The kickoff by the Tigers, and we've got a
– offside again.
Keith, did you know that's the second time we've been offsides tonight? You know, we did something – I think you weren't there last week, we were offsides on the receiving end, you know, in a game up here. And then we did the same thing down there. So, you know, where you're lined up to, I think it was offsides against Belmont or whatever. But you're on the receiving end, and we were offsides. So, you know, that don't happen a lot. And
it's just got to be disciplined.
Oh, Chris Strickland down there watching. He had a game down there at Escambia tonight. I don't know where they was going to come out on the W tonight. Hoping the Strick man is getting a win. Strick, we got a good one here, 28-28, 4:33 to go. Now we're going to have to kick off at our own 35-yard line. They're going to get great field position. Here's a kickoff, Murray. Murray kicks that ball high. They're going to field it at the 30, 35. Up to the 40. They've already run one back for a touchdown. He goes to the 45-yard line, just short of the 45.
Yeah, Mr. Colin Humphreys, number 17, made that tackle. He locked on that time. Had a baby.
So we've got first and 10 for Sheffield. And Sheffield, I don't know what the time of possession has been here tonight, but Sheffield has milked a lot of clock all night long. So we're going to have to have a defensive stand. By the Tigers. Yeah. They're going to have first and 10 at their own 44-yard line. Thank you. Consider the Lilies. They got some of the best pricing around on diffusers and oils. Come in and see them for all the floral and gift needs, essential oils. And you can call them at 356-8313. Over 100 years combined experience in the floral industry. Old Bryson Ferris out there, what Chris Bauer said, only way to watch it. So keep it up. And there's a handoff, and guess what? They got a guy that's going for a touchdown. So the Bulldogs get it to the outside, Keith, and kind of tell them what happened on that play.
We were just outside play on the offense's right, and no one touched him. As number 21, he's a boy dog, and that comes running that ball, and we hadn't stopped him much all night. So he went all the way for a touchdown.
So Sheffield, who had watched the Red Bay Tigers tie this game up 28-28, didn't take long to score. There's still 4:17 to go. And if you're going to score, I'd rather them score then than
that gives us a little more time.
Yeah. So Sheffield with a chance to add it up. This guy's been perfect all night. Now we got a flag. I think they had movement on the line. You know, Chris Bierbauer said the only way these guys, you know, they're in the military, the only way they can watch it is if we do this. And we appreciate you. And, of course, I got an amen there from Bryson Ferris. What Chris said was the only way for us to watch, keep it up. Miss Yolanda Cox out there, Miss Ina Strahan, I guess that's watching from Dearborn Heights, Michigan, go to the Tigers tonight. Headed back to Memphis, went to watch Caleb Burrows play baseball. Couldn't make the game tonight, so really enjoying being able to watch it live. And Miss Judy Perrigan, Tracy Elliott out there.
We give it right back to them. We line up all side. So we're going to be back where we originally started.
Chris Bierbauer said he misses you, Keith.
All right. Chris, my buddy. Love you, buddy. Get back, Red Bay, come see us.
Danny Latham out there, still plenty of time to win this one. So you guys, we appreciate you very, very much for being a part of Red Bay Tiger football tonight. We've had an awesome audience out there that's been with us all night long. Remember, we couldn't do it without you folks being a part of the broadcast. So the extra point, it is up, it is good. And that will make it 35-28. So Red Bay Tiger football tonight is a production of Ivy Broadcasting. We appreciate Red Bay Rentals, Johnny Weatherford, 256-668-0039. Always free locks, they're always on us. Call today and ask how you can get a free month of storage. 24-hour tenant access. He's got video surveillance. He's even got 10x10 climate control storage at Red Bay Rentals. Also, big shout-out tonight to Davis Ford down in Fulton. Been in business over 50 years, serving the area. Proud sponsor of the game tonight. Thank you, Mr. Buster. 662-862-3711. And also, big shout-out tonight to Bunny Gray at Davis Realty, that great-tasting Carl Lewis sausage, Dr. Stephen Ray's Family Dentistry, also Gary Armstrong. It does all your Dozier backhoe work. By 4th Street Grill and Steakhouse, Lori and Brent Collin. By Ronnie Cook, your Modern Woodman agent, 662-423-8477. The Red Bay Hospital, along with Triple D's Bucket Service, by Paige Clearing, Joel Caroline, and Jody Page. And right now, it's time now for the kickoff by Sheffield. They'll kick off from the 40. Right to left. Kick going a little deeper. It hits, and the Tigers can't pick it up. They're going to have to go back and pick it up at the 7. They'll bring it to the 10. This is Kobe King, and Kobe is going to be knocked down shy of the 20-yard line. They're going to mark it close to the 19.
There's a flag, too. We may be farther than the 16.
You think the flag's on them?
On us? It could be on us.
Yeah, it is. So the flag is against the Red Bay Tigers. Live coverage of Red Bay Tiger football tonight, live from Fred Bostic Jr. Memorial Stadium, brought to you tonight by Mike Schubert, your hometown school board member, by Sunshine Mills, makers of that great cat food and dog food, by the Red Bay Gas and Water Department, 356-8622, and also your hometown Piggly Wiggly in Belmont. Red Bay and Iuka, home of that Piggly Wiggly daily menu.
Going to be starting from the 8-yard line, Jack.
That's about where we picked it up after it got by us. I see old Engel back out there, Elijah, going back this series.
Number 6 is out there. So
So the guys that kind of left injured earlier are back out there. A lot of folks. As the Tigers hand it off, and we're going to lose yardage on the handoff. Not a lot of time here with 3:59 to go. We're going to have to hurry up. 35-28 Sheffield. 35-28 Sheffield. New Albany leading Tisch County 48-6 after three. Tigers, we'll see what to do right here. So there's the snap. Quarterback has to fall down on it, and he's going to lose it back to what, about the
one-yard line.
Was that a crazy snap or just didn't field it clean or what?
I don't know. That's not good.
Not good at all.
It's going to be third and third and 19, something like that, 18.
Ooh, man, that's a bunch. So the Tigers have got their backs to the wall. We're going to have a big, big, big play here. 35-28, 2:44 to go. A lot of clock going off. We got two receivers to the left. Got to get a first down. There's a pass, incomplete.
Yes.
And that was up to about the 15-yard line. So the Tigers going for Rooker on that one. And
we
got
to punt it.
Fourth down. You can't give the ball to them on the 1 yard line.
That started bad from the time they kicked off. We fumbled the kickoff and then got a penalty on the kickoff and then didn't get anywhere on the first play, and then on the second play we snap it over his head, and so it was just bad all the way.
Samaria end over end kick. They don't put anybody back. It's going to get out to about the 42-yard line, 43. That's where Sheffield have it at the 43.
That's as good as we could hope for. 2:25 left in the game.
So Sheffield's going to have the ball. If they can run some clock right here, they'll get out of here with a big region win tonight.
Yeah, we hadn't stopped them all night.
They've
punted one time, I think.
Appreciate Community Spirit Bank on our broadcast tonight, along with the Cardinal Drive In. Don't forget Tiffin Motorhomes, sponsor of Red Bay Tiger football tonight. Alpha Insurance, Mr. John Cook, the Medical Clinic of Red Bay with Dr. Fabianchi. Mike Engel at Engel Farms, along with Stadium Pros, Keith Kennedy, Alton Barksdale, and Bay Tree Gift Company out on the Golden Road. They're going to go to number 21 again. He broke it to the outside. This time he gets it inside the 40. Down to about the 38-yard line before the Tigers are there to make the stop. Mr. Meyer over there.
Yeah, Mr. Meyer made that in on that tackle. Jalen Vincent and Kobe Bragwell.
Tigers play, I believe, Sheffield right here Monday night in a JV game. We have got a timeout. Second down and 8. Let me listen to that Red Bay Tiger band just for a second, Keith. And the Red Bay Tiger cheerleaders down below performing. Sandwich. We appreciate everybody that's joined us on the broadcast here tonight. We got second down and 8 for the Sheffield Bulldogs. Red Bay trailing 35-28. And Sheffield's got the football.
Yes.
Quarterback back to pass, and we're going to throw for a loss back at the 45-yard line. So now we're going to get another timeout. He's going to lose all the way back to the 46-yard line. They may give him a little forward progress to the 45. So it'll be third down and about 13 to go. So Tigers get a timeout. Don't forget, you can always watch the band's halftime performance on our TV replays. You can go on my YouTube channel in the morning and watch the game. Defense! Once again, this is WRMG TV 12 and also Television 97. We'll have an interview with the coach. We'll hear what he says to the team after the game tonight before we get out of here. And don't forget, we'll be on the road next Friday night. The worst-case scenario, you can listen on 97.9 AM 1430, Channel 12. If you don't have any of those, you live out of town, you can always go to our website, WRMG. Got to put the radio in, WRMGradio.com. And click on the Red Bay link and listen to the game. Well, Kelly Moore has said the Clemson Tigers has gone down tonight, Keith.
Uh-oh.
27-24. Uh-oh. There's Matt Davison out there watching tonight. Here we go. Big play. Third down at about 13. And the quarterback's going to pull it down, and he's going to get back to the original line of scrimmage. So it's going to be fourth and 10. Now, the question is, we do have a timeout, and we're going to call it. That will probably be our last timeout.
That's all of them.
Now, how much time is left?
1:58.
1:58. It's not over yet. It's not over yet, folks. I don't know how many yards 21's got.
I don't know. He's a good little athlete. You have to get those arms around him and lock up and get those shoulder pads on him.
Boy, hey, after Red Bay had come back and tied the game up, boy, what did he do? Took it to the house.
Yeah.
Miss Evelyn Williams out there watching tonight. Miss Evelyn, how's it looking over on your street tonight? We appreciate all you folks that joined us on our broadcast. Once again, post-game interview with Coach as soon as you hear him talking to the players. We appreciate Deaton Funeral Home, along with Fastway Car Wash, Tiffin Motor Homes, Dr. Ralph Nix, Albin Mason Construction Company. Told you about Spark CPA Firm, Bay Tree Gift Company.
We need old Rook to run this and buy it's what we need.
There's the snap, and they're going to punt it. And the Tigers are going to call a fair catch at the 10-yard line. That was Rooker that called for the fair catch.
1:52.
Miss Evelyn says it's looking great over on her street tonight. Appreciate Ronald Thorne, your State Farm agent. After thousands of calls throughout the years inquiring about insurance from their neighbors over in Mississippi, guess what? He can take care of all your insurance needs in Alabama and Mississippi. Ronald Thorne, 356-4459. Also, Wicked Marinara, serving that great pizza from our family to yours. Got the scratch.
Have you had some of that pizza yet?
Yes, sir. Made from scratch cheese sticks.
All right.
Pizza. Five cheese ravioli, shrimp alfredo. I'm not a big eater, so, you know.
No, huh.
Predator Pest Control on our broadcast tonight. Thank you, Clay, Ted, and Mr. Eddie. Red Bay Pharmacy tonight. Thank you, your Edward Jones agent, Mike Jones. Quarterback back to pass. Looking, threw it right to the Sheffield Bulldog, and guess what? He got an interception. And that one's over. Intended over on that side. I don't know who it was intended for. It might have been Rooker over there. But we threw it right to the guy in the white shirt, and he got the interception, and that's going to be all over but
that's
crying
it.
Now. Sherry Yarber says, I'm watching my cousin Max from Huntington Beach, California. Miss Sylvia Farr Lyle's out there. Farron Criddle out there tonight. Michelle Wooten, Jamie Scott, thank y'all so much. And Sheffield just intercepted it, and they'll be able to run the clock out now with no Tiger timeout. Sheffield leads 35-28. We got 1:47 to go. And we got a region game next week down at Seligent. Then we got, of course, Field Camel here and Cherokee to end of the season, but two more of those region games. And Tigers have put themselves, especially losing to Mars Hill. And if they could get, I don't even know what the chances are or what. We don't worry about that tonight because there's nothing we can do with it tonight. But old Keith Ledbetter out there watching tonight. But the Tiger's going to come up short. We got an injured player down out there.
That's Max.
Max has already had to have some help coming off one time, and I believe it's going to have to happen again here. Hopefully Max is going to be okay. Swamp John's a big sponsor of the game tonight. And they're going to help him up now. Franklin County Probate Judge Barry Moore, Allen and Ash Harden at Harden Heating and Cooling. Thanks for the broadcast from down in Tampa, Florida. Tracy Elliott said a good job on this end there. Thank you so much, Coach Mayfield and Miss Lavelle out there. Miss Donna Weatherford, thank you. Donna, I know, is really excited about not only having Belmont Pharmacy, but having Red Bay Pharmacy now open out on the Golden Roof. If you hadn't had a chance to just go out and browse, why don't you go out there and just look around and see what's new in Red Bay. Thanks to Bill and Donna Weatherford and their great staff. Appreciate all the folks that's watched us online at Facebook Live tonight. And we'll keep doing everything we can to maybe improve the broadcast. Hopefully it looked good enough at your house tonight that you enjoyed the broadcast.
Second down five. They're on the 14.
This game, quarterback going to pull it down, run it. We're going to stop him and stack him up short. The line of scrimmage, it doesn't matter. They're going to run the clock out. Yeah. 58 seconds. They'll only snap it about one more time. 35-28.
One more time, and they can get in that victory formation.
Proud of the fight and our Tigers. Thank you for bringing the game to the world, Mr. Jack Ivey. Danny Latham, we appreciate you. Judy Robinson, Kilby out there. Good to hear from Mr. Michael Fancher out there. Michael, we were talking about you and your family earlier.
Yeah. And love old Michael.
Oh, I guarantee it. Michael, send the love from all of us here at WRMG and all the fans. We love you all very, very much and been praying for you, I promise you.
That's it.
And tell the rest of the family. And the clock is going to run out. We're down to 12 seconds, and they're heading to midfield to shake hands right now. 35-28. 35-28. So if you're out there joining us on a broadcast, a tough one for the Tigers to lose tonight. And it all started off not good, Keith. I mean, they got a couple of quick scores early.
We got fired up and played a little heart and passion there in that second half. And we just need to start it that way.
Ken Williams out there tonight. Thank you so much. Ricky and Cindy Mitchell, Greg Burleson, Royce Miller out there tonight. Thank you all for watching.
Jack, we've got a pretty good string of making the playoffs going.
Oh, I know it. And last year we're going to have to go on the road, folks. I can tell you about that. So, you know, that's not all bad all the time. You know, we've won some road games, haven't we?
That's it.
And so we'll take a road game if we have to. But Alan Mayhall, thank you so much. Appreciate Tracy Gordon out there, Susan, Gary Puckett. Thank y'all. Appreciate everybody that's watched us online. Don't forget to, by the time you get up in the morning, you can go watch this video on demand at youtube.com. Just search Jack Ivey and scroll down. You'll see the game. We got an interview with the coach coming up. We're going to see what he's got to say about this game tonight. Appreciate John Mattson once again, and Terry Hester, thank you all for being out here tonight. I know we missed some folks, but I promise you folks, we appreciate y'all. All the folks over in Kuwait, y'all continue to pray for them, and once again continue to pray for the Fancher family tonight. We'll send it down to Keith, and he's got the coach. Let's see what coach can say to keep these guys' heads up.
Come on, Brack. Hey, do we have Max?
No.
Okay. Come on, Engel. All right, hey, guys, I tell you what. We kind of challenged you at halftime. Let's go, take a knee. We kind of challenged you at halftime to come out and play second half hard, and you did that. And I'm proud of you. All right, that took a lot of guts to come back with the things that we did the first half and come back and fight them like that. So, hey, we appreciate that. You come back and you fought hard and you made it a game. And hey, we just got to get over the hump with it. I know you're upset. The second half, we'll take that. All right, some of the things we did in the first half, we got to get better at that. All right, you guys, it's banged up, and there's a bunch of you now. All right, we haven't got much time to rest. We basically got a playoff game on the line next week. Has everybody got it?
Yes, sir.
As soon as we take a prayer, we're going to go say the over here at the alma mater. Here we go, Take it in.
Chard in heaven, how we down it. We come, how we down it. Appreciate it. Give us day, baby. It's not temptation.
Get over there, go.
Appreciate Redmond Heating and Cooling along with Bay Diesel and Air Conditioning. Dr. Rick Wooten at Wooten Chiropractic, also Tiffin Supply, Tiffin Appliance Company, Harden Heating and Cooling. And we're going to stand by and talk with the head coach for the Red Bay Tigers. Here's Keith Kennedy with Coach Michael Jackson.
Coach, we sort of dug us a hole that first half, didn't we?
Well, we did. And we challenged them hard at halftime because I wasn't very happy with the things that we did. We didn't come out with the same intensity we needed to build off what we did last week and the week before that. So, but the second half, we come out, we fought hard, gave ourselves a chance to win the game. We knew coming in the game that they had their two guys back healthy, the quarterback and Carroll. So we knew that was going to be the key of the game. We have to tackle those guys. First half, we did a terrible job tackling both of them. But the second half, we come out, we hit them, and did a better job with it. But when you're playing guys like that, you got to keep them bottled up. So I was proud of some of the guys having to play through what they was going because we had a couple starters there that we was looking for a formation to line up in at the end of the game there because we had our two best top guys out. But I was proud of the effort. We got to come back against Soldier. These guys got to get well. It's a big game. But second half, I'm proud of that effort. First half, we didn't play very good.
Well, you know, I was telling Jack that first half. I said, Jack, we ain't gotten any motion, any passion about it. And you come out that second half and played it with emotion, and we just got to get started that way. So hopefully we can go over and Soldier. It'll be a great challenge for us. Probably the best team we played this year.
It'll be the best team we played this year. They handled Sheffield pretty good, but now when they handled them, then they didn't have the running back, so it was a little bit easier for them. So, but it's going to be a big challenge all week, and you know we're going to have some more young guys step up. It looks like because if we got a couple older guys out on defense, then we're going to start a couple more underclassmen.
Well, Coach, we'll see you next Friday night over at Soldier.
Yes, sir. Thank you.
Okay. Coach. All right, Jack.
Appreciate it, Keith. I just got the word that New Albany final score, New Albany 48, Tishomingo County 14. And, you know, Belmont was trailing 20-19 at halftime. Well, Belmont has kind of took off in the second half, leading 39-20 with 3:20 games. So that'll get the Cardinals a little extra boost getting into the playoffs. They're probably going to have to travel like the Red Bay Tigers before it's over and head over to the Delta. But the main goal is to get in the playoffs, and if you have to play at home or on the road, you do what you got to do, and hopefully maybe win some games in the playoffs. And we're going to have to go down there with our backs to the wall next week, and we may need some extra folks to step it up a little bit, but I know these guys are going to be challenged this week, and hopefully they can go down there and stand up to the tasks. But it's going to be a tough one, right?
All right. We'll see you.
Appreciate you, Keith. Keith Kennedy down on the sideline. That is going to wrap up our broadcast. We're live tonight, not only on WRMG, TV 12, and TV 97. We've been live tonight on 97.9 FM, AM 1430. We've been streaming live on WRMGradio.com, the Red Bay link there. And also, we've been streaming live on Facebook Live tonight. We hope you've enjoyed our broadcast. Tons of folks have watched tonight. We'll have this game, like I say, on YouTube in the morning. But as soon as I finalize this in a minute, you can actually go back and watch it again on Facebook here shortly. So we hope you'll do that and share the broadcast. Once again, thank you so much for everybody that listened tonight and watched. Appreciate Denise back at Control Center doing a great job as always. We couldn't make it without her, I promise you. Byron Hillam's giving you these great shots. And for all the crew, I'm Jack Ivey saying thank you so much. Once again, your final score, Red Bay Tigers lose to Sheffield tonight. Sheffield 35, your Red Bay Tigers are 28. That's your final score, and this is the Red Bay Tiger Football Network.